welcome to the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series here on CW57 Sports. It's been a long season, and it culminates in this, our final game of the year, the Cheese Bowl, live from Curtis Jones Field in Verona, where the Madison Memorial Spartans will come in to take on the Verona Wildcats. Both teams sitting at 6-2 should see a lot of offense tonight, and more importantly, a big rivalry game that has implications on playoff seeding as we go into the rest of now. Well, the postseason here with high school football, and it's starting to feel like postseason football here. It's a cold night here in Verona, and as I said, a big rivalry matchup tonight, so we should see a good game with 2-6-2 teams.
Yeah, absolutely. Both teams coming in hot. Memorial's won 6 games in a row. Verona's won 4 games in a row. Both teams are in perfect shape heading into the playoffs, and that's what makes this game kind of a big game, because you want to keep that momentum going into the playoffs. Hot teams usually seem to go far. You don't want that losing or to start the week before the playoffs. So for both teams, I think they come out really charged up for this game, trying to carry the momentum they currently have into the postseason.
And you'll have Verona, who's traditionally been a pretty good team, and beating Memorial. The things Adam Smith has done with this Memorial team in just one season are very impressive, going from a losing club to now at 6-2 going into the last week this season. Very impressive. He's a heck of a coach. I had the opportunity to play for him, and what he's doing here at the Spartans is impressive. So we're
real quick
to see
turnaround.
A good game.
Yeah, you know, you talk about having a really quick turnaround. They do it on offense. They can pass the ball. They can throw the ball. And they've really stepped up defensively, too, and they needed that when they were able to beat Middleton. So, yeah, this is a team that's on the come, definitely. And I think when you look, it's because they've been able to balance a little bit, both offensively and defensively, and put the 6-game win streak together.
So we're expecting a great one here tonight at Verona. A lot of offense on the docket. You are tuned into the Al Byers pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. Verona taking on the Memorial Spartans right here on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Curtis Jones Field here in Verona, as the Wildcats will be taking on the Memorial Spartans. It is the Al Byers pregame show, and as always, from Al Byers, we have in Dan McHugh. Dan, thanks for joining us here today.
Oh, absolutely. It's a pleasure being here. It's actually been a pleasure being a sponsor of the championship series.
We've loved to have you all season long, and one of the things we were just talking about, it's almost a little bit bittersweet to have the coverage coming to an end here, because I know I've learned so much over the season and what I need to do at home to keep my stuff in great working order, and the weather here tonight is another reminder that you got to get your furnace checked just for this reason. You don't want to turn it on a cold night and have nothing happen.
Yeah, absolutely. As a matter of fact, if people haven't turned on their equipment, at least test it out right now, they're certainly going to tonight, because it's pretty darn chilly.
And another thing you guys do, also going with the cold weather here, fireplaces. Fireplaces are important. They're a great luxury to have, whether they're gas or whether they're actually wood. That's something you need to get checked out too before winter comes.
Right. We always want to make sure people have good, safe operating equipment. Mm-hmm. Make sure their chimneys and their flues are clear and clean. If they're gas, make sure they're burning appropriately. Making sure they're prettied up also. Yeah. The embers are all set and the gas pressures are correct. And it makes for a really nice, comfortable time for the winter time.
Fantastic. Now, one more time for you at home, how can our viewers get in touch with you and Al Byers to have their home checked out?
Well, they can certainly get online and go to www.albyers.com, or of course just give us a call at 608-752-6610 in Janesville, or 608-423-4480 in Cambridge.
Fantastic. Well, once again, we do want to thank you for being a part of this all season long. It's been a pleasure for me to talk to you each and every week. So I got to ask, for the last time this season, who's your pick tonight between the Wildcats and the Spartans?
Oh, this is going to be a big battle. This 6-2 for both. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's going to be it's all going to be laid out here on the field.
All right, we'll see what happens. We'll talk to the coaches coming up. You are tuned into the Al Byers pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. We'll be right back on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the Al Byers pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. We are at Curtis Jones Field here in Verona, as the Wildcats will be welcoming in the Madison Memorial Spartans. And joining us right now is head coach of those Spartans, Coach Adam Smith. Coach, thanks for joining us here today.
I appreciate being here.
So at 6-2, a huge turnaround from where the Spartans have been in the past. And obviously part of that is going to be not only the talent you have, the coaching staff you brought in, and you as a coach as well. Can you talk to us a little bit about the turnaround at Memorial and what's led you guys to be at 6-2 and looking at playoffs this season?
Well, it starts with Spartan Football Nation, and we really wanted it to be a community and bring people in and keep people involved, giving them a sense of empowerment so that they actually feel a part of the, you know, the success that we're having out here on the field through parents, administration, coaches, everybody that's involved with the school. We want them to be a part of it because we can't do it where we want to be. We can't get where we want to be without them. So it started there, and then with our coaching staff, we brought in a great coaching staff and doing a great job of teaching and caring and getting these guys prepared to come out and play on Friday nights.
Yeah, some of that success, too, predicated on some of your offense. We're watching, actually, Emmett Enright, your quarterback, throwing behind us 20 touchdowns, 1,800-plus yards. Tell us a little bit about his play so far this season and the play of the offense.
Well, the play of offense has been a little bit you might think it's been great, but we've been getting better, and I'll keep it at that. Our run game has been getting much better, and I think that's helped Emmett a lot. And now we're trying to slow some things down and really figure out what he's really – we're still figuring out things, believe it or not. I wish we had these kids for another year because it would be fantastic. But it starts up front with all our coaching staff has been great, and Emmett's been doing a great job getting better every week, and I think that's a good thing.
Now, as I mentioned, coming in tonight at 6-2, team on a really hot streak right now. Seating still available for the playoffs. What's something you guys want to learn tonight, or maybe a key to victory to get maybe a little bit better seating as we get in through the rest of the postseason?
Defensively, play sound, play fast, play hard. Offensively, protect the football. We're going to be okay.
You're a week away from the playoffs. How important is it to keep that win streak going and keep that momentum going?
We don't think of it as a streak. We think of it as a standard. And that's a lot different than in the past. And this is the way it should be at Memorial. This is the standard that we're setting for our football program. And we're just trying to get better one game at a time. So we're facing a great Verona team tonight. It's going to be a great test, and it's going to propel us to do great things in the playoffs.
Love it.
Fantastic. Adam, thanks for joining us here tonight, and good luck.
I appreciate it. Go Spartans.
We'll be right back with more of the Owlbiters pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. You just heard from Coach Adam Smith. We'll be talking to Verona here in just a moment, right here on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the Owlbiters pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series here on CW57 Sports. Joining us right now is the leader of those Verona Wildcats, Coach Richardson. Coach, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having us. Thanks for having us on TV. That's awesome.
So, 2-6-2 teams tonight, both going into the playoffs, both riding a very hot streak right now. What's the key going forward as the playoffs are beyond you to get that, not only that streak going, but make sure your team's ready and staying hot to hopefully go far in the playoffs?
Yeah, let's finish this season and start the next season. We're rooting for Janesville Craig real hard, and we're hoping that we play a good enough game to come out on top. But we're focused on here and now, and tonight we can have some fun looking at what the future holds. But this is an important game for us.
Looking back on this season and back on your winning streak, and Carson Parks has been a big part of that, getting nearly 8 yards per carry. How's he doing that? Is it the offensive line, or is he just that good?
Well, I'm really proud of our offensive line, but we've also got two wingbacks who are pretty solid, and so you can't key in just Carson. We've got that rolling a little bit too. So we try to spread out that defense a little bit and hit them where they ain't.
And you mentioned talking about that defense tonight. They're going to play a big role in this because that Memorial offense is potent. What are some of the things you guys have been working on this week to try to slow them down?
Well, as much as you like to think they're a pass-first team because they spread, they're not. They want to run between the tackles first and foremost, get behind Jack Andringa, and let things happen. So our front five, front seven have to play pretty well tonight. And we want to stop the run and make them a one-dimensional team.
It's senior night here for you and last game of the season at home. What does it mean to get those seniors out on a high note?
Well, it's pretty cool, especially this group of seniors. This night's always special, and a lot of tears flow before the game. It's just kind of neat that parents allow us to coach their kids and spend a lot of time with them, especially the last couple of years on varsity. And it's just a proud moment for everybody seeing what we're going to graduate. And I tell the kids all the time, you know, how good is our team going to be? I'll tell you in 20 years when these seniors are dads and people in the community and doing the right thing all the time. Yeah.
Well, Coach, we want to thank you for joining us here on the pregame show and wish you the best of luck not only tonight but in the playoffs as well.
Thanks. I appreciate that.
Coach Richards of Verona. We're going to be right back with more of the Al Byers pregame show, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl series, right here on CW57 Sports. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another production of A1 Furniture Bowl Series, the final one of the season here on CW57 Sports. My name is Ryan Ashker. Alongside is Rich Reynolds, and we have a heck of a game tonight. Both teams are 6-2 coming in, a big rivalry game. These teams do not like each other. We are in Verona, where the Wildcats are going to welcome in Adam Smith and the Madison Memorial Spartans. Now, Coach Smith has done a great job kind of turning around this Spartan team. They're 6-2 in his first year as a coach and looking at the playoffs this year.
Yeah, I tell you what, after talking with Coach Smith, I was fired up and I wanted to play some football. He is a breath of fresh air.
Yeah.
And one of the great things I love, you know, asking him, hey, you're coming in hot, you're coming in on a winning streak. He's like, we don't look at it as a win streak. This is our standard, and he's reset the culture for the Spartans and has them flying high. Gotta love a guy like Coach Smith. That's the kind of guy you want to play for.
Well, he's a fantastic coach. He's done a great job at Memorial. I had the opportunity to play for Adam with the Madison Mustangs for several years. Great guy, knows how to connect with the athletes, which is very important, and he has these Spartans riding high. And you mentioned what he was saying during the pregame show. Very impressive getting the crew out there in that pregame show, of course, brought to you by Al Byers Comfort System. Feel good in every room of your home with Aprilaire Zone Control available at Al Byers. Feel good inside. It is going to be Verona kicking off from left to right to start the game. Memorial going to start tonight on offense, and they have a very potent offense. Like to run the spread, but they're also a very good running team.
Can't wait to see them. We saw them in the warm-ups, and boy, do they have a huge target in Jake Ferguson. They're going to be fun to watch.
And here is the kick. Deep kick going to be received at about the 5-yard line, taken out across the 10. Running across field, tries to turn it up, taken down by a Wildcat right at the 10-yard line. And that is where Memorial will start off. That was taken back by Giselle Taylor for the Spartans.
And something that you don't like to see when you're on special teams is running east and west. You want to get more north-south. Take what you can get right away. There wasn't much there, and it puts Memorial in an early hole.
Emmett Enright, the quarterback for the Spartans, standing at 6 foot, 185, the senior. Big line set up in front of him. More of a pistol formation here for the Spartans. There's going to be a handoff coming back over to the left side. Going to find an opening. Loses a man. Picks up a good gain on the play. That is Terrell Goodwin.
And you talked about a big line and right up the middle. How about big number 78, John Adams, 6'4", 320, and a senior. He's the center that's snapping the ball. And, boy, it's nice to have a big horse like that right in the middle that you can run behind.
And you see how quick the Spartans are to the line. That's kind of a staple of Coach Smith's offense here. Four wide receivers. Handoff once again to Goodwin. He's going to lose one guy behind the line of scrimmage, try to turn it up, and there's going to be a whole slew of Wildcats there to bring him down. That'll bring up second down. The previous play was good enough for a courtesy Ford first down.
Both teams' defenses come in, and they can do certain things at times. There are both attacking defenses, and you'll see them make plays at times. It's been consistency for both sides that I think the coaches have been a little bit down upon, as every once in a while you see them give up big plays.
You can tell by the mannerisms of some of these kids how cold it really is out tonight. There is a nice pass to the far sideline. Going to be tipped by Verona and pulled down for the completion. That is Jake Ferguson, who you talked about just a little bit earlier. Big target standing at 6'5". The junior weighing in at 200 pounds has tipped off a Verona defender and right into the hands of Ferguson. You see here on the KJ replay. There's the tip, there's the completion, and then hit out of bounds. All replays are brought to you by Kjerstin Goggin, Dane County's premier realtor. If you're buying or selling, visit kjsellsmadison.com.
Great concentration by Ferguson there to be able to haul the pass in after it was knocked in the air. And like I said, you know, he's a huge target. He ran by me on the sideline. I'm like, wow, look at this kid. 6'5", and a good guy to throw to if you're Enright.
And Wright going to hand it off to the fullback this time, who is lined up to his right. That is Jake Andringa. Andringa, a senior, 5'9", 220. See here, just a little quick hitter. He's going to take it up to the left side.
There was room there on the left side, actually, but the defense had everything bottled up in the middle, and if Andringa could have got away, there was green out there. It was a good job by the offensive line to bottle up the defense in the middle. All Andringa needed to do was get outside.
Handoff once again for Memorial. Right up the middle, that's enough for a courtesy Ford first down. Again, they go to Goodwin on the carry, number 22, and he's having an impressive start to the game.
Great start for Goodwin. Three carries, 25 yards, gets a first down there, and a great job of just following his blockers, finding a path. He didn't overrun it. You'll see sometimes guys get too fast, and that ends them has them end up getting caught. He didn't do that. He was patient and was able to find a hole for 12 yards and a first down.
More of a wishbone set there. Enright breaks through. Enright fumbles. He's going to try to fall on top of it, and he's going to keep the ball. Scary moment there for the Spartans.
Serendipitous, to say the least, there, as Enright had immediate pressure up the middle, was able to get away, and a nice strip. I thought, actually, that Enright had just dropped the ball, but he was stripped, if you could see on the replay right there, and luckily for him, very fortuitous, is that it came right back into his hands after a nice strip by TJ Hollis.
One of the most impressive things of the season here is how much Rich's vocabulary has grown throughout the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series. More of the wishbone setup once again for the Spartans. There is the handoff. He's going to take it up the middle. Picks up about a yard on that carry. That'll bring up third and looks to be about 7 or 8.
You like serendipitous and fortuitous?
Serendipitous and fortuitous. Now, one of the things I was talking to you about in the pregame are the new helmet decals for the Spartans. I absolutely love those.
Yeah, very cool look, and that whole Spartan green that they have going on as well. And, yeah, that's a good-looking look, I guess, for them, or a fashion. Now my vocabulary is gone. I've lost it. They look good. You're right.
Shot it off too early, Rich. All right. Three wide receivers set to the right side. Enright looking to throw the right. Has a man wide open across the middle. That's enough for a courtesy forward first down, and that is Jake Ferguson once again.
And why not throw to Ferguson? He's the leading receiver on the team. And you can see he has just a way of getting open and is such a big target for Enright to hit. I'm sure he's got a lot of faith in Ferguson. He goes to him often. And already now that's 4 first downs on the drive for this high-powered Memorial offense.
Ferguson only a junior, so he still has another year to progress in this new offense here for Memorial. Bad communication there on the snap. As you have Goodwin running into Enright, Goodwin still able to pick up a big chunk of yards. And that will be just short of a first down, bringing up about 2nd and 1 on the play. Good recovery there for Goodwin.
And that's because of that big offensive line. Ishmael James, 5'9", 280, a senior. 78 again, John Adams, 6'4", 320, opening up the hole there.
Goodwin coming down now next to Enright on the left side. Enright fakes the handoff, tosses one to the end zone. That's in for a touchdown, a Hunter Peters. Touchdown, Memorial Spartans. That is a J&K Security Solution touchdown. Home theater, home security, and now home automation. J&K Security Solutions integrate your world. And that Spartan offense marches it down the field very convincingly. And they're going to pick up 6 to start the game, pending the extra point here.
Skinny post pattern by Peters and a nice throw by Enright. Hits Peters in stride towards the back of the end zone and a quick 6 for the Spartans.
Carl Hummel to attempt the extra point. It's going to be blocked and still go in for Hummel. That makes the score 7-0, 7:45 left in the first quarter in favor of the Memorial Spartans. You are watching the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the A1 Furniture Bowl Series here on CW57 Sports. We're in Verona, where the Wildcats will take on, or are taking on, the Madison Memorial Spartans, and the Spartans with a great opening drive, and that led them to seven. So now we'll get to see Verona on offense as the Spartans will be kicking off from left, from right to left. And the key there was running, great running there by Terrell Goodwin of the Spartans, and he really carried that first drive.
Goodwin set up the passing. You know, if you can run the football, then that helps the pass game so much. And we talked about it early on in our pregame show, balance. And it's one of the things that jumps off the page when you see this Verona team is how balanced they are on offense, and it showed on the first drive.
Not a great kick there by the Spartans. That's going to lead to Verona taking over at about the 41-yard line. And we'll see what this offense can do. I love that bunch kickoff formation that the Spartans do. That's something I've been very familiar with. And it's really entertaining to me to call this game and be able to watch the Spartans, because this is the offense I played against for 5 years.
Yeah, this is what you know. And so, you know, you get to see it live and in action. And, boy, it goes back to being able to run and pass. That balance really is tough on a defense.
Here is the run up the middle for Verona. That'll be a nice pickup on yards. And on that carry will be number 23, Carson Parks, the senior. Parks having a good season for the Wildcats up till now.
Parks comes in as the leading rusher, 97 carries, 771 yards, popping off for just about 8 yards a carry and 10 touchdowns on the season. So, yeah, he's having a great year.
Eight
so far.
Yards per carry, that is unbelievable. Here is the handoff once again. Parks will dive ahead. Lawinger actually on the carry there. And it's going to be close to a first down. Looks to be just an inch short.
Just shy there, and a nice job of getting through on defense as coming up and making the stop was Ferguson. So going both ways, he was able to fill that gap. That's what they call like a run fit, and being able to fit into there and stop that run from really getting off the edge. And a nice job by Ferguson to bring up third and short.
Third and very short here for Verona. There is going to be the handoff. That's going to get punched ahead. Fumble on the carry. Spartans say they have it.
Wow, we've already seen the ball on the ground twice. The Spartans were able to get back their own fumble, and it looks like they got this. They did.
And that's going to be Memorial Spartans football, a huge turnover for Verona. And coming away with the ball for the Spartans, that was Jason Wea.
Absolutely huge, as after scoring quickly on a drive, if you're Verona, you want to bounce right back. They started off in great field position, looked like they had a first down. The ball squirts away, and now all the momentum squarely on the side of the Spartans right now. And you got to figure that, hey, you know, Coach Smith's going to come after them and move the ball down the field again.
Spartans going to take over on the 47-yard line, so short field for them. Enright, of course, back in at quarterback. Productive first drive of the game. Second chance we have here to see the offense in motion. Enright drops back, decides to hand it off. Big gaping hole there down to the sideline. One man to beat, cuts it across. And inside the 20, a huge run there. That was Terrell Goodwin once again, and Goodwin having a monster first quarter. That is a courtesy forward first down.
And a pickup of 44 yards as they caught Verona on defense. They got sucked into that draw play and were too far upfield, and it left the middle wide open. You called it a big gaping hole. It was, and it was from here to eternity, and Goodwin was able to run through it. 44 big yards, and the Spartans are on the doorstep to taking a big early lead.
Want to thank our friends at Courtesy Ford. Courtesy Ford in Sauk City, your new truck destination. Enright hands it off once again. Going to the far side, lowers a shoulder over a man, picks up about a yard on the play. That was Jason Wea, who recovered the fumble initially on defense for the Spartans.
And a nice job by Bryson Smith to hold his spot and upend the running back. That's an open field tackle there by Smith coming up from the safety spot. If he doesn't make that stop right there and the back's able to evade him, that's a touchdown. So a nice job by Smith on the tackle.
All right. Enright going to keep it now, toss it off to the far side, lowers the shoulder, and down to about the six on the pitch to Goodwin. Nice fake there initially from Enright to Wea. And then the toss out to Goodwin.
Little trickeration there, trying to catch the defense napping, kind of an option play and a good pitch that time, and nearly again broke it. It looks like the Spartans can almost break through on every single play.
Yeah.
Everything's very aggressive on offense. Not a lot of passive offense or plays setting up other plays. It's very aggressive. They're going for the jugular.
And this could be an opportunity to see Ferguson. And they're going to toss it off to the corner of the end zone. That is knocked away, and miscommunication there between Enright and Adam Smith Jr.
Yeah, I think Enright for sure thought someone was going to be there. In fact, nobody ran that corner route, and he just threw it to a spot expecting someone to be there. But someone got mixed up on that, and there was definitely a bad signal.
Yeah. A.J. Smith, who's been having a good season, Coach Smith's son. Miscommunication there with Enright. Now they're going to go for the three. Carl Hummel. And it was low, and that's not good. Wide to the left there on the kick attempt by Hummel. You see here on the KJ replay, kicking it very low. And it just goes wide left. So that'll give Verona now an opportunity to get back into the game with 4:27 left in the first quarter, down 7-0 here at home on senior night. And that's something we haven't really touched on yet tonight either. That's a lot of emotions going on for these upperclassmen this evening.
Absolutely. And those upperclassmen right now all just wiped their brow and went, whew, because they dodged a bullet right there. And now Verona can recapture some of the momentum right now, getting a couple first downs and a drive going here.
Hand off right up the middle. That's not going to go anywhere.
All right, nice job right up the middle that time by Memorial. It was number 57, Jack Peterson, 6'2", 250, holding the spot and getting the tackle.
Verona a bit slower to the line than the Spartans have been. More of a wing tee setup formation, handoff, quick hitter right up the middle. And the Spartans all over that. Another short pickup for the Wildcats. Wildcats, as you can see, all black, orange trim. Spartans in that the sharp green pants and helmet, white jerseys, green numbers.
Carson Parks with the short carry there, and we're going to see, I think, Verona throw for the first time in this game. The bad thing about this is you don't want your first time to be throwing when it's third and seven and a predictable throwing down.
And looking to throw, he's got a man open across the middle, and that will be complete. So they'll pick up the courtesy Ford first down. And I'll have to see the replay here to see who that actually went to.
I think that was number 80, Lance Andrew.
Lance Andrew. The orange numbers on the black jerseys are a little bit harder to see than I would have anticipated, actually.
They looked really good out on the field, and close up I thought was pretty cool. That sticks out. The highlighter crown, or all the all pink, looks
pink.
Really good, yeah.
Another quick hitter up the middle there. So the coaching staff being very cautious with the junior Max Finken at quarterback. A lot of quick hitters, only having to throw when it's necessary.
Yeah, we're seeing two contrasting styles at this point. So where the Spartans were being very aggressive, the Wildcats are doing it the other way. So they're trying the middle. They're testing things out. They're looking to set things up. And so these belly plays and these quick hitters and what have you are hopefully going to set something up to the outside. But it's a completely different concept than what we saw from the Spartans.
Another quick hitter up the middle. Pick up maybe 2 yards on that carry there for Verona. And on that carry, it was Drew King.
This time a little counter play off of that, and not much there, as you got to say, at least early on, as Memorial's really holding the line. They're winning on both sides of the football right now at the point of attack. And so Verona now comes in. They got a third down. It's about 5 here. It's a run or pass kind of a situation, but you got to figure that this might be another throwing down, especially by seeing how tough that the Spartan defense has been up the middle.
Very tough. Big bodies in the middle. Very athletic for Memorial. They are going to hand off on the lead play, and that's not going to go anywhere as the Spartans eat that up. And that'll bring up about 4th and 7 on the carry. There was Nick Lawinger once again for Verona.
And not only did they have 8 in the box, they had number 8 in the box, and that's Jake Ferguson again. And he has been relentless on defense as well. We knew we were going to see some offensive firepower from Ferguson. I just didn't realize that how good he was on D. That's a good two-way player.
Ferguson prefers to play linebacker. If he plays anywhere after high school, I don't think that'll happen with a 6'5 frame. Booming punt, and Verona's going to get down there and put it down at just across the 10-yard line. So the Spartans will take over at about the 9.5. We'll see if Memorial can get something going here on their third drive. Just about done with the first quarter of play here in Verona. You're watching the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Verona, where the Memorial Spartans have just taken over on offense, leading the game 7-0, 49 seconds left in the first quarter of play.
Great punt by Verona, actually has the Spartans pinned back. But, hey, they started at their own 11 on their first drive, mm-hmm. went down and scored a touchdown. So I don't think there's a lot of panic here if you're the Spartans.
And Wright takes a snap, going to hand it off down the middle, breaks a tackle and picks up just a little bit more, making, I guess, a little bit of something out of nothing for Memorial. That is Terrell Goodwin once again.
That play looked like it was absolutely stuffed, but a nice job by Goodwin. Keep the legs going, was able to pick up 3 yards on first down and a little bit of breathing room for the Spartan offense.
And that's going to be key here, especially if it comes up to a passing down where you don't have your quarterback launching one from the end zone.
Four wide once again for the Spartans.
And Wright looking to throw. Throws to the weak side, has a man open, and that's going to be completed across the 20. Should be enough for a courtesy forward first down as Hunter Peter pulls that one down.
One thing for sure is that Verona is going to have to bring those corners up, mm-hmm. because that's just way too easy. And we saw in the pregame, Memorial just running those routes over and over and over and these little quick hitches and these little curl routes, and they'll take that all day.
All right, it is the end of the first quarter, and the Memorial Spartans are leading the Verona Wildcats 7-0. It is the Cheese Bowl here from Verona, and we'll be back with more of the A1 Furniture Bowl series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Curtis Jones Field here in Verona, where the Wildcats are welcoming in the Madison Memorial Spartans. Wildcats are down 7-0 as we begin the second quarter of play. And so far, the offense for Memorial has been very impressive. And you know what? The defense is backing that up as well.
It has been the line play so far of the Spartans that has really set the tone on both sides of the football, whether it's on the offensive line or the defensive line. And if you can control the line, you can usually control the game. And through the first 12 minutes so far, that's what it's been. It's been the Spartans controlling the game, and it's because of the big guys up front.
I want to take a moment to thank my friends Dave and Dooley of Legends, proud supporters of the Madison Memorial Spartans. Legends Sports Bar and Grill, 439 Grand Canyon Drive in Madison. Food, drinks, Packers, Badgers, Brewers, and Bucks. Get all you need at Legends Sports Bar and Grill. Feeding our staff here tonight and fantastic food. Good friends of mine over there, David and Dooley, so thank you guys very much. As we have four wide once again for the Spartans.
I recommend the Philly, by the way, was terrific tonight.
And right, waiting for the snap. And that one's going to be whistled dead.
Delay a game
on the Spartans. Also want to thank Kelly Stelzer, proud supporter of local high school athletics, your knowledgeable and trusted realtor. And that is our first penalty of the night, an O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag. A big thank you to O'Reilly and their commitment to support local high school athletics. Better parts, better prices every day, O'Reilly's.
Yeah, thanks to Legends. Again, the food was fantastic. I tell you what, the radio guys are next to us, and their buffet was nothing. So, you know, it's kind of nice to be on the TV set.
We have it pretty good here as we get a big toss-up once again. That one intended for Hunter Peters. That goes incomplete for the Spartans. That'll bring up second and 15. We want to thank Paul and all the folks over at A1 Furniture once again, thanking them for being our official Bowl Series sponsor, locally owned and operated since 1980. Find them on the West Beltline Highway or South Stoughton Road.
Misfire there by Enright is actually, though, he had plenty of time in the pocket and probably could have went to another read.
Good defensive play there as Goodwin gets eaten up in the backfield for the Spartans. Stay tuned after this quarter. We do have the Mad City Frites halftime show. Visit Mad City Frites on State Street and experience the best fries in Madison.
Trayvon Johnson of the Wildcats, 6'5", 250, a senior, was able to shed a block and then just stood right there and wrapped up Goodwin. And that's a nice defensive play as he held his ground, didn't over-pursue, and made a textbook tackle.
Four wide for the Spartans. Enright looking to throw. Cross the middle, has a man open. He's going to spin out of it and get taken down. That'll give him past the original line of scrimmage. That pass goes to Jake Ferguson once again. And that will bring up a fourth and 8 for Memorial. And for the first time tonight, we're going to see the Spartans punt team come onto the field.
Emmett Enright already on the night has completed 5 of his first 7 tosses, 65 yards. 3 of those passes to Jake Ferguson, who has 38 yards receiving so far. Doing a nice job of throwing the ball, but that time 3rd and 15. There aren't a lot of plays for 3rd and 15.
And there is the punt. Not a bad punt. That'll be received at about the 35-yard line, down now across the 40. Coming to the near side, out, and he'll be taken down at about the 44-yard line, and that's where the Wildcats will start playing. It's for me, it's deja vu watching the special teams of the Spartans. This stuff was ingrained in my head. And, you know, one of the unique things that Adam did when he took over this Spartan program, he actually brought in quite a few of his former players and Mustangs to help out and coach this team. I had the opportunity to be a part of that for a while, but TV took me away from that. We have the old Mustang quarterback, Dave Petroyak. He's up here in the booth. They also have former backup quarterback, Dave Hapkin, tight end, Patrick Rohde, all on this Spartan coaching staff. As there, we have a good run for Verona. But bringing in people that are that knowledgeable in that offense, that's just helped Adam instill everything a little bit quicker.
Yeah, I think it's even more than knowledge. What you also have are coaches that are already bought in. They know the system. They know each other. They believe in each other. And that translates to the team. All of a sudden now, if the team sees that they're bought in, they start following the leaders, and you'll see that kind of buy-in. And that kind of buy-in leads to success, like a 6-game winning streak and a big win over Middleton.
And here we got another run up to the near side. That's going to be Nick Lawinger once again. And Lawinger, the junior, we knew we'd get to see a little bit of him tonight, but he's having an impressive game so far as well for the Wildcats, being the second tailback in the offense.
Lawinger comes in with 374 yards on the season at 4.5 yards per carry, getting just about 50 yards a game so far. So, yeah, he does see quite a bit of action. And one of the things that Coach Richardson talked about is if he can get the ball, it takes some of the pressure off Carson Parks.
Mm-hmm. And there is Longer once again, backtracking, going to the far side of the field, going to be forced out of bounds by the Spartan defense, and good job of pursuit there. Also want to thank Little Caesars. Little Caesars of Verona, proud supporters of Verona High School Wildcats. Little Caesars Pizza, Dane County's first and only hot and ready pickup window. Little Caesars, go Wildcats. And folks, if you've been tuning into the A1 Furniture Bowl Series, you know how good Rich and I and the entire crew eat. So we can't thank Legends and Little Caesars enough tonight, as I think we're going to be going home with some pizza.
Absolutely. There was, I don't know if it was like a dozen pizzas down there. I'm like, wow, this is a veritable buffet, and it was fantastic.
Confusion there for Max Fink, as he will be forced to take a timeout. That is a Toyota timeout. Toyota, let's go places, as Fink didn't have the right play call in there. Also want to thank Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. Call now and get $40 off their thorough and professional precision tune-up your furnace. Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, you will feel just right. The A1 Furniture Bowl Series, of course, brought to you by Paul Cannarella and all the folks over at A1 Furniture, our official Bowl Series sponsor, locally owned and operated since 1980. Find them on the West Beltline Highway or South Stoughton Road. So with Verona forced to take a timeout there, it gives both teams a moment to recoup. It has been a very clean game so far. The only penalty we've had is that delay of game by the Spartans. But so far, the Spartan offense and defense has just been a little bit too much for this Verona team to decipher and really make a play on.
Well, one of the things you really got to at least see is that the early part of the game, it's been a lot of Memorial, but Verona's only down by one score at this point. And so they got the ball. They're driving. They've done a good job of hanging in there and, you know, kind of, you know, stemming this tide so far. And now they're coming back, and they got a chance to go ahead and score and even this game up. So I like at least the result so far in the Wildcats to stick in this game and not let it get too far out of hand.
And that's going to be a false start on the offense. A legal motion there. That's going to fall on Logan Beal.
Now, I think that falls on you because you said they didn't have any penalties up until this point, and
that's
so
true.
It's all your fault, Ryan.
And that will be another O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag. A big thank you to O'Reilly Auto Parts and their commitment to support local high school athletics. Better parts, better prices every day, and you will not get a penalty flag from buying parts at O'Reilly's.
Look at that segue. Wow.
Not
nice
bad, I know. You'd think I got paid to do this. I actually just went to our partner O'Reilly's this afternoon and bought some new wiper blades for the truck.
Needed it, huh?
Needed it, especially before winter. And there is going to be the handoff coming now to the near side. Could find an opening outside, going to be taken down by a host. The Spartans picking up about 2-3 on that play. See here on the KJ replay, just more of an end around. On that carry was Carson Parks once again, and that is a name we expect to hear quite a bit of tonight for this Wildcat offense. But now on a 4th and 5, they will be forced to punt it back away to the Spartans. And if the last punt is any indication, this kid's got a leg. More of a rugby-style kick looking to coffin corner him. Fair catch called, and they're going to take the ball at the 10-yard line. And smart decision there to call for the fair catch because there's Wildcats all over him ready to pounce if he wanted to return that ball.
Very impressed so far with the Verona Wildcats special teams. One thing that it's really allowed them to do is force the Spartans to go the length of the field.
Correct.
They were able to do it on the first drive, but it's hard to sustain a drive and go 8, 9, 10, 12 plays and execute every single one of those plays. So a nice job by the special teams right now, the Wildcats, keeping them in this football game.
Pistol formation, four wide receivers on the field. Another miscommunication there in the backfield for the Spartans as Enright was looking to hand off. Running back went to the left. Enright turned to the right and ended up having to take it himself up the middle.
Usually this late in the season, you don't think that you would see miscues like that and everybody would be on the same sheet of music. But Enright, I tell you what, his guy wasn't where he was supposed to be, but he still had the presence of mind to say, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and run this thing.
Yeah.
And a great job by the offensive line to hold the blocks as he got 5 yards out of it.
Pistol once again, kind of the go-to formation here. Handoff once again for the Spartans. Looking to the left side, charging ahead. And that'll bring up third and very manageable here for the Spartans.
If at that point, for peripheral vision, right here, if Goodwin would have decided to go right, I think he had a big gain, decided to keep on going left behind his line, was still able to fight ahead and get actually a first down. They're going to move the chains on
they
that.
Are.
So a pickup of 5 and a first down by Goodwin.
That will be a Courtesy Ford first down. Courtesy Ford, your new truck destination. Looks to be a bit short from up here, but they're going to give it to him. Great camera work there by our sideline man, Mahai. Getting you right on the line here this evening. Another pistol formation. Here's the toss out to Goodwin. Goodwin stops, goes, does the Pennzoil thing up across the middle. That will bring in an O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag, and that is in the area of holding on the offense.
Once again, it was number 67, Trayvon Johnson, that just blew that play up. Look at him push the tackle into the backfield, fights him off once again, and it forced Goodwin to go back inside, and then the holding penalty comes out as well. But that was just a beastie play by Trayvon Johnson, who's having himself a game so far.
You see that pressure that Rich was just talking about on the KGA replay. I want to remind you that all replays tonight and all season long have been brought to you by Kjerstin Goggin, Dane County's premier realtor. If you're buying or selling, visit kjsellsmadison.com.
A lot of teams like to run right, and you see that a lot. But they're running right at Johnson if they keep running right. And it might be the point where at some point where Memorial says, you know what, we're going to try running left a little bit more. They got a big offensive line. They can hold it at the point of attack. But I think right now,
Trayvon Johnson's winning that battle, and you might want to go away from him.
First and 20. Pistol formation. Four wide receiver set. Enright hands it off. Not a bad pickup there for Goodwin.
Good stutter step. Nice little juke move. Nice job. As you see, it's the feet of Goodwin that time that allows him to get into space and pick up 8 yards.
And Coach Richardson mentioned in the pregame, it looks like Memorial would be a really pass-happy team, but they don't. They run it quite a bit. Love to run between the tackles, and that's been the difference in the ballgame so far as we are under 7.5 minutes left in the half.
10 carries, 98 yards so far for Goodwin.
Four wideouts once again. Close on the right side, split on the left. Handoff for Goodwin. He's going to go nowhere. Stay tuned for our halftime show brought to you by Mad City Frites. Visit them on State Street and experience the best fries in Madison.
And who's is it right there? There it is again. It's Trayvon Johnson, who moved from the left side to the right side and was able to go through two blockers, the two big guys up the middle and at left guard, and he split them and was able to hold the point of attack and hold Goodwin back. Boy, Trayvon Johnson right now is kind of unstoppable.
Second and 13. I'm sorry, third and 14. And Wright looking to pass. He's going to find the close, the running back. He's going to dive ahead looking for the first down is Goodwin. And that will be close. We'll see where they mark Goodwin.
Yeah, it all depends on the spot. I thought he had it, and a nice job by Enright to set up that middle screen. And look at Goodwin go. He's able to get away from Johnson as the Verona defense gets there late, but I think he picked up the first down, and he did. They'll move the chains.
That'll be enough for the courtesy Ford first down.
Great play call.
And starting from a first and 20, very impressive drive here once again for the Spartans. Another first and 10 as Enright's awaiting the call.
Already 8 first downs here in the first half for the Spartans, and none bigger than that one. So now instead of punting deep in their own end, now they're kind of flipping the field. Mm-hmm. And so Ferguson, we already saw, has a good foot on him. At the very least, you'll be able to pin the Wildcats back.
Enright looking to pass, launches one across, finds his big receiver Ferguson, and that'll be out to about the 43-yard line.
You kind of got the feeling that they could do this all night long, and I talked about it earlier. They were running those hitches and hooks and these little patterns like that, and it's a first down again as they move the chains, but it just seems like Ferguson can get open whenever he wants to, and his height definitely helps with that.
A lot of four wide out here for the Spartans. Offset on the near side. Handoff once again. Pickup of about a yard. Want to thank our friends at Albiers Indoor Comfort System. Feel good in every room of your home with Aprilaire Zone Control available at Albiers. Feel good inside.
Already over 200 yards of offense for the Spartans here in the first half as they've had long fields to deal with. Mm-hmm. That's why they only have 7 points on the board, that and the missed field goal. But they've had a lot of long fields, but they are getting chunks of yardage here as this offensive line has really been dominant.
Enright option to the left side. Enright going to keep it, charge ahead near the first down as he's pushed out of bounds by the Verona defense.
Good decision there by Enright and a good read coming off of the end right here as whether to pitch it or not. And once his man, he was reading number 34, that was Sam Favor. Once he dipped to the inside, Enright just took it to the outside, very nearly picked up that first down.
That'll bring up second and one here for Memorial. Third and one for Memorial. The man on the stick tonight is not on his game.
No, he's not.
Got announcers trying to go off your stick, buddy. Come on now.
What an interesting formation here.
Adam has some creative stuff. Coach Smith for the Spartans. Here's one of them. And Enright fakes the handoff, keeps it himself, goes to the far sideline. He'll pick up a courtesy Ford first down and much more. As you said, a creative play there, and that will bring in a late flag, an O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag, and that could be an illegal hit out of bounds on Verona. That's about that area that it falls in.
It was formation that set it up. It was also the quick feet of Enright, and it was also a great read by Enright as well as he held onto that ball and just scampered to the outside. Good blocking once again. everything seemed to go right on that play for Memorial, and that's something that they've definitely rehearsed and then executed very well.
Call now and get $40 off a thorough and professional precision tune-up of your furnace with Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. You'll feel just right. Give those guys a call. They're actually coming over to do my house this week. Another great partner here on the A1 Furniture Bowl Series, as that is what the call is, a personal foul on Verona. So that'll just extend the impressive courtesy Ford first down that Enright picked up and move the Spartans closer to the end zone. Keep in mind, they started this at about the 10-yard line again.
Again, it's like the third drive that started around their own 10, and they just keep moving the ball. Lots of attacking plays so far tonight for the Spartans, and I'm very impressed with their execution of those plays as well.
Goodwin takes it up the middle, picks up maybe two on the play, and Goodwin making a case for himself right now to be the Kelly Stelzer MVP. Kelly Stelzer, proud to support local high school athletics, your knowledgeable and trusted realtor.
And if he's not, did you see who made the tackle again? It was 67, Trayvon Johnson. He is impressive.
Everywhere.
Watching him. His motor is going tonight.
And looking at too high there defensively. Enright lost the ball.
And Johnson pounced on it. I mean, he is just a disruptive force right now as Trayvon Johnson comes up with the football. Wherever he goes, chaos follows. He actually pushed the man back and slapped. He slapped out that football.
He forced the fumble and recovered himself. Trayvon Johnson, very impressive play there. And that takes the wind out of the sails for Memorial as Verona causes a turnover here. And they'll take back over on about the 15-yard line.
That's one of those plays you just want to say, dude. I mean, amazing to come in and slap away that football and then pounce on it himself. Amazingly athletic and a good motor play.
And he breaks a couple tackles, comes to the near sideline. He's running open and gets taken down. What an impressive run there coming through the line for Carson Parks.
Carson Parks looked like a man on fire running this football as arm tackles just were not going to take him down. Look at him go right there, and
three,
then using the stiff arm to create another 20 yards as he was just, I mean, high energy run right there. You got to secure that football,
six,
I think, a little bit better.
The
but
seventh
still, good
man
run.
Took him down on that.
Wow.
Impressive run by Parks, getting through six Spartan defenders before finally being taken down. And that is a very impressive play for this Verona offense. Fakes the handoff now on the end around. That is Longer once again. Longer picking up about three on the play, bringing up second and seven here for the Wildcats. Once again, want to thank our food sponsor this evening, Legends, my friends David and Dooley over there, proud supporters of the Madison Memorial Spartans. They're located at 439 Grand Canyon Drive in Madison. Food, drinks, Packers, Badgers, Brews, and Bucks. Get all you need at Legends Sports Bar.
Turnover battle tied at one, but it looks like the Wildcats really got fired up after that last turnover. This offensive line now is starting to get some push.
Another big opening there for Parks to go through. Parks picking up, looks to be about four. We'll see where they mark him down.
Straight up the middle, it's Ferguson making the tackle this time, as Ferguson has been everywhere as well. So far, it's kind of been like the Ferguson versus Johnson show and, you know, going back and forth as these two big 6'5" seniors have been, or actually Ferguson's a junior, these 6'5" players have been dominating play. But now Verona, a big third down here. If they can convert, they keep that momentum going.
Third and a long two here. Looking to throw, open man across the middle. That's going to fall incomplete. That was intended for Hunter Bourne, and he was wide open there as Fink was looking for him across the middle and just bounced off his hands.
Poor Hunter Bourne, the leading receiver on the team, and Verona doesn't throw all that much, but, you know, he was wide open, hit him right in the breadbasket. He dropped the football. That's a horrible feeling when that happens, but I thought it was a great play call by the Wildcats. And now Coach Richardson has been playing the field position battle. Here's a spot again where you think maybe they can go for it and keep the momentum going. With only 2.5 minutes left in the half, he's going to try and pin Memorial again.
Well, it's worked for him so far. You see another one of those rugby-style kicks. Tries the coffin corner. Goes right up the middle. Another fair catch called. And he'll be down at about the 16-yard line. And the Spartans have another big field to try to overtake with 2:20 left in the half. And they've been moving the ball The problem is execution at the end of the drive trying to get in the end zone as they have one turnover down there and we're forced to punt once again. But they've been moving the ball quite a bit so far in this game. Also, while we have a moment, I want to thank Little Caesars. They hooked us up tonight. Joe Vanchick and his family of Little Caesars in Verona, official sponsor of the Wildcats. The first and only hot and ready pickup window in the area. Little Caesars, go Wildcats.
You talked about the Spartans moving the football. 10 first downs, 222 total yards, but just 7 points to show for it as they've had long green fields to try and overcome.
And that means a lot of the reason why they've been able to move the ball so effectively tonight. Terrell Goodwin picking up another courtesy Ford first down as he continues to rack up the yards here for this Memorial Spartan offense.
Well, what it is, too, I mean, that left side of the line, it's really getting a lot of push. I mean, wherever Trayvon Johnson isn't, that's where the line's getting pushed. And so I think, really, you got to run away from Trayvon Johnson at this point.
Pistol formation, four wide receivers, the basic offense here for the Spartans. Handoff once again to Goodwin up the middle. And he's not going to go anywhere on that, bringing up second and 10 here for the Spartans. Thank you to A1 Furniture, our official Bowl Series sponsor, locally owned and operated since 1980. Find them on the West Beltline Highway or South Stoughton Road.
That time on the weak side of the defense is Trayvon Johnson. The overload came on the strong side where almost everybody else on the defense was. And that's what the Spartans ended up running into, and that's why there was no gain.
Under a minute and a half left to play in the first half. Enright looking to pass, fires one downfield, and that's going to be complete. Going to hustle back up to the ball as Hunter Peters pulls it down.
Nice throw by Enright, just dropping back in the pocket, five-step drop, and hits Peters in stride for the first down as Enright has a lot of completion so far here tonight. 7 of 9, 90 yards throwing the football.
No huddle once again for the Spartans. Enright has the snap, looking to pass, under pressure, getting chased to the near side, escapes one tackle, keeps the ball himself. Going to get past the line of scrimmage, pick up about 5, but the clock is ticking now, under a minute here. This is the 2-minute offense, and you know Memorial works hard on this, or as I like to call it, Lambo tempo. Very upbeat 2-minute offense style of play, and that will be a timeout on the field, a Toyota timeout. Let's go places, and you know what? We'll do the same. We'll be right back here in Verona. You're watching the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the Cheese Bowl, the A1 Furniture Bowl Series here on CW57 Sports. We're at Curtis Jones Field in Verona, where the Wildcats are welcoming in the Madison Memorial Spartans. It is senior night here for the Wildcats, and they are down 7-0, 50 seconds left to play. The Spartans will take over on about the 45-yard line of Verona, looking to drive it in before half here. They've had a very impressive first half of offense, just unable to get more than that one score. Trip wide receivers off to the right, single to the left. Enright fires it across the middle. And a smart play there by the receiver, lowering his shoulder, getting out of bounds. And once again, that is Jake Ferguson. And Ferguson, not only an athletic play, but very smart. You see here on the JK replay, catches it in the middle, ducks a couple defenders, and then runs it right to the sideline to stop the clock with 40 seconds left. And the Spartans now at about the 21-yard line.
Ferguson was just a square in and then was able to use his athletic ability to outrun the D and get out of bounds and stop the clock.
Enright looking to pass. Goes the end zone, has a man open. That falls incomplete just over the head of Hunter Peters.
Wow, one of the few misfires that we've seen tonight from Enright. Had Peters wide open and just missed dropping it into the bucket right there, as Enright has been firing on all cylinders tonight with his feet, with his arm, and just missed, though, there on a wide open little out pattern for Peters.
33 seconds left on the clock. Clock, of course, stopping on an incomplete pass. We're at 2nd and 10 for the Spartans. Enright hands it off, open, down the middle, lowers the shoulder, and just short of the end zone is Terrell Goodwin.
Great
at about
call.
The 1 yard line with 25 seconds left. Timeout taken by Memorial. That is a Toyota timeout. Toyota, let's go places.
Absolutely terrific call. I was just going to say, you know what, 33 seconds before they snap that football is actually a lot of time.
It is.
You know, for the Spartans, and they don't have to pass on every down. They were able to run. Nice call because Verona's thinking pass, pass, pass.
Yep.
They sucked that pass rush in, run the little draw play, and it was wide open up the middle. Goodwin very nearly took it to the house.
You know, a lot to be thankful for here tonight. You know, obviously we've had the honor of calling the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series all season long. Rich, I want to thank you for coming on. But something else we're thankful for is our producer Tony's all right, as he was in a bit of a traffic incident earlier this evening.
Unbelievable, yeah. It kind of even smashed up our trophy a
little
bit.
Smashed up our trophy a bit.
It smashed up our Tony a little bit. So kind of worried about him. I hope that he's going to be all right. He says he's fine. He seems like he's a tough guy, you know, kind of like that tough Southern, you know, kind of a guy. And I think he's going to be okay, but you never know in those types of collisions. I'm just glad he made it here.
Well, I tell you what, Tony, if there's some lingering effects and you're hurt and don't show up to work Monday, me either, I'll be taking a day off as well. But no, you know, glad you can make it here, Tony. Glad you're all right. The car seems to be in okay shape. And that's the important part as the Spartans run it again across the end zone. Touchdown, Memorial. Into the end zone. Terrell Goodwin once again. And that is a J&K Security Solution touchdown. Home theater, home security, now home automation. J&K Security Solutions integrate your world. And actually, that was Jason Wea on the touchdown for the Spartans. Wea with an impressive carry getting his sixth tonight.
You know what? You almost called it right, though, because the credit of that touchdown goes to Terrell Goodwin. His block is what made that play happen. He threw himself in there. Without that block, Wea's thrown for a loss. Instead, Goodwin sticks his nose in there. And I tell you what, when you get so many guys to block for you so that you can have all these great runs, it's going to return the favor, and his team's going to love that block.
Oh, yeah. Carl Hummel will come on and attempt the extra point. Hummel converted on his extra point, then missed a short field goal as it went wide left. Here's the one-point attempt, and he's been kicking it low. Verona's been able to get in there and get pressure on his kicks here this evening. And there, that one goes straight up in the air and is going to fall short, so incomplete once again. That'll keep the score at 0-13 in favor of the Spartans. We're going to take a short break. You are tuned into the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Back here in Verona, where the Wildcats are down 13-0 to the Madison Memorial Spartans, and Carl Hummel, kicker for Memorial, having a rough night here. He has a missed extra point and a missed field goal. And here is that bunch formation that I talked about a bit earlier that Coach Smith runs on the kickoffs, and I love this formation because if you're trying to set up your blocks, you don't know where your guys are coming from. As Hummel's on the kick off from left to right, 18 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, really basic confusing for the receiving team right here.
And just drills it up the middle, going to be picked up at about now, rolling back to the 14, crosses the 15 out to the 20, and he's going to be eaten up by Spartan defenders at the 21-yard line. That's where they're going to take over with 12 seconds left to go in the first half.
And there were defenders there everywhere because you can't set up your blocks. If you've ever played football and you've been on special teams and on a kickoff return team, one of the things you do is say, I got 52.
Exactly.
I got 48. You hear guys calling it out. And you can't do that when that formation is done like that by the Spartans.
And that's one of the reasons Coach Smith runs it that way, and it does make it very confusing for the return team. Now 12 seconds left. It appears Verona is just going to take a knee and take it into the half. And there it is. Stay tuned for the Mad City Frites halftime show. You can visit Mad City Frites on State Street and experience the best fries in Madison. At halftime, the visiting Madison Memorial Spartans are up 13-0 over the Verona Wildcats. It is senior night here in Verona tonight. So you know those seniors are going to be itching to get back into this ball game. We're going to take a short break and be back to the sideline. Actually, we're going to go to the sideline first right away. I'm not sure who we have this week, but ladies, who are we talking to?
Thanks, guys. Well, Janet and I are down here on the sidelines at Verona, where the Wildcats are taking on the Madison Memorial Spartans. It's been quite a game so far at the A-1 Furniture Cheese Bowl, and we're about to head into the Mad City Frites halftime show. We've got a great halftime show, don't we, Janet?
We do. We'll chat with Mark Krika. He's the athletic director at Verona High School. He'll talk to us about a leadership workshop that he hosted here. We'll also chat with some students that attended that workshop. We'll also meet several athletes, state record holders, the champion swim team, golf, so much more. And
lots more. We've got some students behind us. We've got the managers for the team. It's going to be a great Mad City Frites halftime show here on CW57 Sports at the Cheese Bowl here in Verona. So stick around for more. Hey folks, welcome back to the Mad City Frites halftime show. Janet and I are hanging out down here on the sidelines for this Cheese Bowl here in Verona, where the Wildcats are playing. And thanks to these lovely young ladies, they've got some support. So this is Cheyenne, Kira, and Nicole, and they are managers of the team. And we're so glad to have you, and thanks for taking a break and letting us have you for a minute. Talk to us a little bit about what your functions are with the team.
We fill up water and bring out equipment for the team.
Sometimes during practice, we'll help them with homework.
You keep them on their game. You're very important. We know that. We've been watching you.
So some of you have done this a while and some are new. How long have you done it?
3 years.
This is my second year.
My first year.
That's perfect. And why do you do this? I mean, you got to come out here. It's a lot of work, I understand. Who wants to answer that? All right.
I mainly do it for the Snickers and bananas at halftime, to be totally honest.
We award points for honesty.
I would rather be down here than in the stands, and it's more fun to hang out with them.
And I really enjoy watching football. We got some football fans, I think, like to be down here on the sidelines. Well, you guys are doing a great job. Congrats on first, second, third year supporting your team. You guys are doing great. And I understand there's 8 of you. Is that right?
Yeah.
So there's 7 seniors and a sophomore, I believe. So what a big group of people. This team is lucky to have you. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you
for joining us. We've got lots more halftime show here with Mad City Frites halftime at the Cheese Bowl. It's a mouthful, but it's lots of fun. We'll be right back here on CW57 Sports.
Thanks for watching. This is the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. We're down on the field at Verona High School, where the Wildcats are taking on the Madison Memorial Spartans. With us here at the Mad City Frites Halftime Show, we have Activities Director Mark Krika from Verona High School. Mark, thanks for taking a few minutes here. Appreciate it.
We appreciate it, Mark.
Earlier, we were talking about this leadership conference called the Big 8 Leadership Workshop. Mm-hmm. That you hosted here at Verona High School. Talk to us a little bit about that, what it entails, what's the deal?
Well, the leadership workshop is something we started a few years ago. Every other year, the Big 8 hosts leadership conference or workshop for all 10 schools in the Big 8. We had about 120 kids here from the school. We spent the day learning about leadership, what it takes to be a good leader, what it takes to make good choices.
This is for athletes or just any students?
It's mostly athletes. We right now, because the athletic departments pay for it, we take nominations from our coaches. We each pick. I had like 40 kids. I picked 12 out of the 40 from Verona, and you know, I wish I could include everybody. We just that gets too big then. So
I suppose. And you said you brought in someone to be a speaker as well?
Yeah, Craig Hillier from Minnesota. He makes his living writing books and speaking about leadership. And I've heard him probably 15 times in the last 30 years. So he did the workshop for us 2 years ago, and again this year that we hosted here at Verona Area High School.
What a valuable thing, isn't it?
And what a busy guy. We can hear the walkie-talkie going off as we're interviewing you here.
Hope they're not calling me.
Thanks for taking a minute. And I understand, let's talk a little bit about the state girls golf and tennis. So tell us about that if you would.
Sure. Our girls were the defending state champions from last year in girls golf. It scared me.
That's the excitement. That's how excited they are.
Last year we took first. The year before we took second. This year, unfortunately, we got off to a slow start the first day, but we still ended up taking fourth out of the 12 teams that were there. So great for them, a great experience. We had four seniors that it was a little emotional watching them walk up that 18th fairway for the last time, and I know it was for them too. So
doesn't that sound like a proud athletic director right there?
Oh, absolutely. I can hear the emotions coming through a little bit. Well, Mark, you're a busy guy. Congratulations on all your success and things going on, and we appreciate you taking some time to catch up with us today.
I forgot to tell you about the tennis, though. Today was the state girls tennis tournament. Started yesterday. Our girls, we had one doubles team there. They won their first match today. Unfortunately, they lost the second match. So we're proud of all of them, and we're lucky to have some great athletes in Verona.
Absolutely. We went over, but well worth it. So, Mark, thanks a bunch for catching up with us today. Stay tuned. We got more Mad City Freaks halftime show coming up after this.
Welcome back to the Mad City Freets Halftime Show, where the Verona Wildcats are taking on the Madison Memorial Spartans. This is the Cheese Bowl in the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series. And with us right now, Jess and I have Heather and Grace. Now, we just chatted with the athletic director, Mark Kricka, and he mentioned a leadership workshop, the Big 8 leadership workshop that was hosted here at Verona. These two gals attended that workshop, so we thought we would chat with them about that. So tell us why you went to this workshop.
So we're both captains of teams. I'm the softball captain. She's a volleyball and basketball captain. And it was really just a good way to expand on our knowledge of how to be the best captain we can and be the most successful team leaders as possible and meet other ones as well to learn from their mistakes and their successes.
Very good. And what a great learning experience, as you said. What kinds of things did you take away from the experience?
Well, we talked a lot about the mental game that goes with being an athlete, and one of the biggest points that I took away was learning how to discipline your disappointments. When things don't go your way, how to keep that in check and be able to move on in a game-like situation and in life in general.
Wow, what a big takeaway. Well said. The emotional game, the mental game is such a huge piece of sports and such a big reason to be involved in sports. That's great.
And I like how you put in there that it does apply to life in general, so much more than just the athletics. But back to athletics, so I understand that you were a part of a champion volleyball team. You had a really great season. Go ahead and brag on that.
Well, this season we were Big 8 conference champs, went undefeated. We have our conference tournament tomorrow, which we're very excited about and ready to get to play everyone again.
Undefeated, that is big.
Well, great job, ladies. This is Heather and Grace, and great time having you, and so glad you learned so much. What a great playoff of a proud athletic director.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for coming. We've got a lot more halftime show, believe it or not. We've got more interviews coming up. This is the Mad City Freets halftime show at the A1 Furniture Cheese Bowl, and we'll be right back. Welcome back to the A1 Furniture Cheese Bowl. We're down here on the sidelines for the Mad City Freets halftime show. You may recognize these ladies as they were just introduced at the half, but these folks are state champion swimmers, and congratulations to you ladies. Names real quick.
I'm Sophie.
I'm Maisie.
And I'm Bita.
So these three lovely ladies have had quite the accomplishment. So tell us a little bit about how your season is going, because it's going pretty great, I understand.
Yeah, our season is going pretty well so far. We were a bit disappointed at the beginning of the season, but we just got to keep working hard and just
persevere.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, good for you. You've obviously done that.
I understand that one of you is a state record holder. Did I get that right? And
yes.
And is that you?
Yes.
Well, congratulations. What events do you have that in?
I have the 50 free, the 100 back, the 100 fly, and then I have the national public record and the 100 butterfly.
That's big deal. Yeah, that's it.
And we won the 200 freestyle relay last year, and so we have a team actual state record. Like we've never done that before, so that's really awesome.
Wow. That's fantastic.
Yeah, no kidding. What a big deal. So talk to me about the relay team, and what did you tell us about that? Expand on that if you would.
So My freshman year, we got second in that relay, so it was a 200 freestyle relay. And my sophomore year and junior year, we won, actually, both. And then last year, we got the state record. So it was really amazing. We took down a record that's been there for many, many years, and it was an awesome accomplishment.
Wow, no kidding. Well, you ladies should be very proud, because what a great accomplishment. And few great young ladies here, state champions for the swim team. What a great school, what a great bunch of athletes. That's it. We could talk to you all day, but we got to go. We'll be back. We've got just a little bit more halftime show for you here with Mad City Frites Halftime Show at the Cheese Bowl, so please stay with us. Welcome back to the Mad City Frites Halftime Show. We are here in Verona with some Wildcat fans. How are you guys doing?
Woo! Good, good.
It's the A-1 Furniture Cheese Bowl, and these ladies are rooting on their team in jerseys tonight. It is jersey night. Tell us about that.
We chose jersey night tonight because tonight's also senior night, so most of the moms of the senior boys are wearing their jerseys, so we just wanted to do something a little bit different and have fun with it.
Well, it looks good. You guys all look like you're dressed up and ready to cheer on your team.
And jerseys are good for layering. What is senior night? Who wants to chat?
So basically senior night is when we kind of honor all our senior boys who've been playing all these 4 years, and their parents get to walk with them at the beginning of the game, and we all get to cheer them on really loud.
Lots of fun. Well, thanks so much for taking a minute from cheering while the guys are out there warming up, because boy, do they need it tonight on this chilly night. Well, you guys stay warm. Thanks for catching up with us. And that's it for the halftime show. Thanks to Mad City Frites for supporting us. And we'll be back with more football. Stay tuned.
Welcome back to the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl series, live from Verona. And at the half, the Madison Memorial Spartans are up 13-0 over the Verona Wildcats. My name is Ryan Ashker. Alongside is Rich Reynolds. And we saw a lot of offense, which we expected, but not as much scoring as we would have thought.
Over 300 yards of offense, to be exact, actually, in the first half for the Spartans. They racked up 303 yards. We talked about them having balance.
Wow.
188 yards on the ground, 115 through the air. They did it by land and by sea, but it was getting the ball in the end zone that was kind of a problem. They got 13 points out of it. They were stopped close to the goal line. They had a turnover. So some of those drives ended up stalling out. And it would think, with 303 yards of offense versus 86 yards of offense for Verona, that the score would be much more lopsided. It's not. We're in a two-score game right now. It's still a football game, and there's still work to be done for the Spartans.
And there is the opening kickoff of the second half from right to left. The Spartans kicking off to the Wildcats. Wildcats going to have good starting field position at about the 40-yard line on the squib kick from the Spartans. And Verona has a chance to get right back into this game to start the second half on senior night, as the score, once again, 13-0. So a score here will put them right back into it.
And great field position as well for the Wildcats, and they've had good field position tonight. We're on the flip side. The Spartans have had to go over long fields, starting at their own 10 three different times. Now the Wildcats are starting at their own 41. That's great field position to get back in this game.
And here is looking to pass to start the second half. Has a man wide open. Down across 30, down to the 25, down to the 20. And that will be a completion going to Drew King, I believe. Yeah, Drew King is going to pull down that reception from Max Fink. You see here on the KJ replay, starting off in a big way, tosses it right down to the middle of the field. A lot of green around him, and Fink able to pull down a courtesy Ford first down to start the second half of play.
Just two passes in the first half for Fink. He hit on one of them for 11 yards. The second one was dropped. That time they come out, they surprised everybody, and most of all the Spartan defense, and picked up 39 yards and a first down.
Fink hands it off now. Quick hitter up the middle. And that went to Carson Parks once again, the highly touted running back for Verona.
Park's having a pretty good night. 8 carries, 60 yards, 7.5 yards per carry so far for Park. So he's been doing his job so far, and it's been a good push by the Wildcats, especially on that one drive that they got right after the Spartan turnover, after that fumble that was forced by Trayvon Johnson. But, you know, other than that, there hasn't been much going on for the Wildcats. But all that being said, they're only down by 2 touchdowns.
And there is going to be a handoff to the left side. Has an opening as he gets to the sideline. Pulled down hard on the run. That was Nick Lawinger once again.
This time it was a good job by the Wildcat line to be able to string that play out. They held their blocks at the point of attack for a long time, and a nice job actually of finishing the block there by number 68, Josh Hernandez, and that was able to spring the play, and they're close to first down yardage.
Second and 6 for the Verona Wildcats.
And it's going to be a first down. They got it. At least by the 1 yard marker. He already flipped it to first down. Let's see. Yep, first down.
Looked like he was just a bit short on that 2nd and 6 play. That is enough for the courtesy Ford first down.
Like you said, it's been kind of hard to tell with the yard markers here tonight. They have just not been on point. Chain gang needs to step it up a little bit.
They do. Fink looking to the end zone. And nowhere near a receiver. I believe that was intended for Lance Andrew.
Sure, he was the closest one. Fink ends up rolling out to the right. There was nobody there. And he just threw it to no one in particular, but no loss, no foul, no harm done, 2nd and 10.
The Spartan defender was actually closer to that ball when it hit the ground than it was the intended receiver. Verona taking a lot of time to get up to the line.
The pace of play definitely different on that sideline than it is for the Spartans.
Very
as
much.
The Wildcats have been slowing things down all night.
Fink looking to pass once again. Tosses one straight up, and he just launches that through the back of the end zone. That looked like it easily could have been an intentional grounding call, and there is the flag. That's an O'Reilly Auto Part penalty flag. O'Reilly Auto Part, their commitment to support local high school athletics. Better parts, better prices every day, as that call will be intentional grounding as Fink dropped back and just launched that through the back of the end zone.
I understand the call to a point, but what I don't get is the other part of intentional grounding means that you have to be avoiding a sack. He wasn't. He's just standing in the pocket, and there was no pressure on him. He just threw it to nobody in particular. I think the grounding part is because you're avoiding the sack, and that part just never happened. So now let's see. They are going to call the grounding, so they get to march that off. It's a loss and down, and now it's 3rd and a long way to go for Verona.
Want to thank Al Beyers Indoor Comfort System. Feel good in every room of your home with Aprilaire Zone Control available at Al Beyers. Feel good inside. Tonight's broadcast, as well as all seasons, is brought to you by A-1 Furniture and Mattress, our official Bull Series sponsor, locally owned and operated since 1980, found on the West Beltline Highway or South Stoughton Road. Max Fink, number 13, quarterback for the Verona Wildcats. Fink, only a junior, standing at 6'3", 170 pounds.
Third penalty, by the way, on the Wildcats tonight for 30 yards. They also had that 15-yard penalty that helped sustain the Spartan drive in the first half. So there hasn't been a lot of laundry on the field, but what laundry there has been tonight has gone against the Wildcats.
And it will be 3rd and about 19 to get into the end zone. One off receiver to the right side of Fink. Fink on the quick screen. Has his man. Goes nowhere. Great play there by the Spartan defender. Completing that pass to Drew King.
King, his 2nd catch, has 43 yards on the night, but a nice job that time by the Spartan defense. His number 5, Jason Wade, coming on over and laying the lumber on that play to Drew King. 4th down, and it looks like they're going to bring on the field goal unit. I'm almost at the point where I'm thinking if I'm the Wildcats, you're almost in 4 down territory. You know, 2 touchdowns is different than chipping away with field goals.
Robbie Freetag, the offensive lineman, apparently also the kicker, looking at this extra point. Up, and that's going to go wide to the left. Incomplete.
Incomplete attempt there by Verona. So the score will remain 13-0 in favor of the Spartans, and they will take back over on offense.
You know, it's kind of hard to second guess. You don't know everything about a team's special teams and what they can and cannot do, and you have to figure that the Verona kicking so far tonight has been very good. I just don't understand their strategy-wise why you're not trying to go for the end zone again.
Mm-hmm.
At this point in the game, it looks like the Spartans have been able to dominate on both sides of the line. You have a chance to get back in this football game. I think you got to take it. A field goal there doesn't get you back in.
Three running backs lined up in the backfield. Two are going to inch out, put them in a pistol formation for the Spartans. Handoff going to go right up the middle. That is to their big running back who's been carrying them all night. Terrell Goodwin, 6'185", the senior.
And a nice job of blocking right there as well as he's able to fight forward is Goodwin. And Goodwin now his 16th carry on the night and has just gone over 150 yards, given 152 on the night so far.
And here is that lineup once again from the Spartan offense. Almost looks like a Maryland eye, and then it splits out to a jumbo formation. And then sometimes you'll see those two running backs kick out as well, even deeper. They stay in this time, and one will get the ball going up through the middle. That was Jason Wea for the Spartans, picking up about two on that carry.
Wea's got five carries, 14 yards, and a touchdown that he had in the first half, which was a big play. So third down coming up here for the Spartans. If they can extend this drive, it really puts Verona in a bad spot.
Third and a short three here for the Spartans.
Yeah, there's that Maryland eye again.
And you see they split out. And Enright's going to keep it. Looks for a receiver. Tosses one deep to the left. No flag on the play, and that is a good call. The defender was running with the receiver. It was intended for Hunter Peters, and you'll see here on the KJ replay, maybe. Right there, their feet just got tangled up. Both looking at the ball. That's incidental. Good no call on that.
Absolutely, and boy, another aggressive play call. We talked about Coach Smith wanting to be aggressive in this football game. The coaches take a shot there. Third and two, you're thinking run, 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 and they want long on the pass. That's actually a nice job of the Verona Wildcat defense to stay home and not have that receiver running free.
Spartans look to punt it away here. Left-handed punt, left-footed punt. Picked up at about the 45, now across the 50. Down to across the 45, 40, 35, spins it around down at about the 33-yard line, and that's where the Wildcats will take over on offense on an impressive return there. We're going to take a quick break and be right back for the Verona drive after this. You're watching the Cheese Bowl on the A1 Furniture Bowl Series, CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Curtis Jones Field here in Verona, where the Wildcats starting in good field position, down 13-0 to the Madison Memorial Spartans. Big toss here, going to cross the 30-yard line down to about the 28. That is a completion once again for Max Fink. And that went to...
I believe it was Hunter Bourne,
the tight end.
Yeah, Bourne, his first catch of the night. He is the leading receiver on the team. You talked about the field position once again. The Verona special teams have dominated the Spartan special teams here tonight. There's three facets to the game. Offense and defense have belonged to Sparty, but the special teams are the Wildcats.
And they're breaking out across the middle. Go to the far sidelines, trying to get in the end zone. He's going to be taken down just short of about the five-yard line. On that carry was Carson Parks once again. And very impressive run there for Parks. You see here getting through the middle, getting out of the grasp, but Wea turns it up to the sideline, down across the 10, shoved out of bounds finally to about the five-yard line.
Josh Hernandez, we mentioned his name before. It was the block that sprung it right there, and it wide open spaces for Carson Parks and a big first down.
Pass.
He's going to keep it nearly intercepted there by the Spartans, and that was Hunter Parks, the closest one to it. You had Max Fink trying to find a receiver, and Hunter Parks off his fingertips for what would have been a big interception there for the Spartans.
You know, a couple of these passes have been kind of
quizzical. I'm not exactly sure where they're going, why there's not a receiver in the area, what's happening. I'm not sure if it's a miscommunication or what, but you would think there'd at least be a receiver close, and there's been a few times tonight where there's been no one around the football.
It's almost like they're timing routes and the timing's off. And that is going to be a timeout attributed to the Verona Wildcats. That is a Toyota timeout. Toyota, let's go places. We have the ladies down on the sideline. Ladies, who do you got for us?
Thanks, guys, and thank you for taking a break from football for just a minute. You Legends regulars may recognize this crew and this familiar face, the family of Legends joining him as well. David Idini is with us, and tell us a little bit about Legends and family-owned business, I understand.
Yeah, definitely. Myself, my pop, and my sister, actually, all run Legends together. We've been in Madison since the early 90s, working in the restaurant industry, and, you know, we support definitely our local athletics, especially the Spartans, since they're right down the street.
In dangerous territory over here on the Wildcat side, but we'll let you off the hook.
I understand that those Spartans down a good pizza or two, too, when they're over at your Legends.
Yes, those boys can definitely eat some pizza, at least about 20 of them while we're there.
If some of the viewers would like to get their own pizza, where is Legends, real quick?
439 Grand Canyon Drive on the west side of Madison.
All right, well,
back
thanks.
Back to football.
You take us out.
Here we go, back to football.
All right, welcome back to the football game where we just missed a touchdown there for Verona.
And Fink on the rollout, actually a great job of just buying a little bit of time and finding out in the flats Nick Longer, who's able to take it in the end zone on a nice move at the 3-yard line as he's able to jump in and cut the lead in half.
Longer with a J&K Security Solution touchdown. Home theater, home security, now home automation. J&K Security Solutions in a great year world. And we'll have some laundry coming onto the field that will be an O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag. A big thank you to O'Reilly Auto Parts and their commitment to support local high school athletics. Better parts, better prices every day. That will make the score 6-13. Still in favor of the Spartans, and it does appear that Verona will attempt the extra point here.
Nice job of Longer again, just to be able to turn around, smell the end zone, and be able to tiptoe his way in by evading two defenders. Great play.
And kick up. And that looks to be good. That will make the score 7-13. Still in favor of the Madison Memorial Spartans, but Verona finally with a spark there on offense. And that brings them just a little bit closer, just under 7 minutes left in the third here tonight from Verona.
And it was set up by their special teams. A good punt return. They set it up deep into Spartan territory. They had a short field to work with. So the difference in this football game really has been field position. And the special teams of Verona has been keeping them in the game all night long within striking distance because the field position tonight has been tilted to the Wildcats. They're starting at their own 40. They're starting at the Spartan 40. Whereas the Spartans all night long have been starting around their own 10-yard line. Much harder to put points on the board when you got a long field to work with.
Want to make sure we thank Kjerstin Goggin for the replay. That's the only way we saw that touchdown. Dane County's premier realtor. If you're buying or selling, visit kjsellsmadison.com. Verona going to be kicking off here from left to right. This potent Spartan offense will get the ball once again, and they have not had good field position to start a drive yet this evening. Going to pick it off at about the 11. Fakes the end around. And going to bring it out down to about the 21-yard line on that return. So unique return, and got him just a little past the 20. And that is where Sparty will pick up on offense.
And again, a great job by the special teams of the Wildcats because they didn't buy it. And it's something that you thought that they were set up for. So I think it was a good call by the coaches, but they never got out of their lanes. And that's the key when you're doing kickoff coverage. Don't get out of your lanes. The coaches stress it all the time. They stayed home. They stayed in their lanes. And that's what allowed them to stop them.
All right. Back to the pistol formation, four wide receivers for Memorial. Going to be a handoff, looking up the middle, squeaks out to the right side. That is Goodwin on the carry once again.
Yeah, right now you could feel the momentum is definitely shifted in this football game.
Mm-hmm.
It is all towards the Wildcat sideline. And if you're the Spartans right now, I think you need to string together a couple of first downs. Yeah, the nice big plays are always good, but if you can string together a couple first downs, you take the wind out of the sails.
And Wright fakes the handoff, looking to pass, has a man open in the middle. That'll be a courtesy Ford first down and much more brought down to the 45-yard line. Jake Ferguson, the big target there for Enright, having himself a night.
Beautiful pass and a beautiful route run by Ferguson as he's off to the near sideline, runs the square in, and gets free for another first down. He has been running free over the middle and a huge target for Enright. Enright now at 134 yards passing, Ferguson 92 yards receiving on six catches.
Enright looking to pass once again, has a receiver down the sideline. That's going to fall incomplete. I believe that was intended for Adam Smith Jr. That it was. I want to thank Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. Call now, get $40 off our thorough and professional precision tune-up of your furnace. Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, you'll feel just right.
Enright started hot. He's 9 out of 14, that is, for 134 yards, but he has missed on 3 out of his last 4 passes.
Enright looking to pass again, this time as Ferguson. Right side of the field, that will be enough once again for a courtesy Ford first down. Courtesy Ford, your new truck destination.
You ever watch the old NFL films and there's Hank Stram saying, it's just like stealing, it's just like stealing.
It's about That's what just it is like with Ferguson.
It's easy enough and they're matriculating the ball down the field. Another Hank Stram-ism, if you will. 16 first downs now for Sparty.
And here with a big open field and finally taken down. That is Goodwin.
I think he was just short of the first down as he finds an open spot. But then some good hitting right here as you see the corner coming off the end and sizing him up was number 11, Brandon Daniels, to get the hit in on Goodwin after a pickup of 8.
And we have Goodwin down on the field, so we're going to take a short break. We will be right back. You are watching the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports.
Thanks, guys. Just taking a quick break from football. With us, we have two ladies from FFA. We have Jamie and Lauren joining us tonight. And just a quick update on what FFA's mission is, Jamie.
We're a youth organization that works on developing students' leadership skills, personal growth, and career success.
And Jamie, you're the director of FFA. Is that the correct title?
I'm one of the advisors.
One of the advisors. And you are a senior with the program. So talk a little bit about what you guys are out here doing tonight.
Tonight we are doing the concession stand, which raises money for all of the volunteer activities that we do, such as the mitten program, which raises toys for families in the school district who cannot afford toys for the Christmas time.
So as you're out getting your hot dog, you're also supporting a great group of folks who are helping give back to the school. Thanks so much for taking just a minute with us, Jamie and Lauren. We appreciate it. Back to football.
Welcome back to the game. Enright's going to take the snap, hand it off. New running back into the game. We, of course, hope Goodwin is all right after being helped off the field there. Now running, that is Jason Wea. Is here on the replay, not a lot of room for Wea to go.
And we haven't mentioned too much of Trayvon Johnson here in the second half, but he did a good job right up the middle of stepping up and stopping the play. He took on two offensive linemen, and that's what held the play up.
That one will be completed over to Hunter Peters for Memorial. And that will be enough for a courtesy Ford first down.
Nice catch that time by Peters, coming back to the football and just able to hold on as he now has 4 catches for 49 yards on the night.
Enright waiting. There's the snap. Enright looking to throw as all day. Launches one down near the end zone, and that is going to be completed for his first catch of the night, Alex Battaglia. And I was just going to make a comment about Battaglia. He's had his hands in his little warmer the entire night. So I was wondering if the coaching staff was staying away from him because that's kind of easy to read, and then he comes up with a nice catch.
And a good throw, too, by Enright, who had a ton of time in the pocket, was able to go ahead and do some camping, pitched a tent, was able to make a sandwich, some s'mores, then threw the football, and Battaglia's inside the 10-yard line, first and goal.
There's going to be the handoff up the middle. That's not going to go far enough in as Jack Andringa. There with the attempt. You just saw our friends from Legends Sports Bar. David and his dad, Dooley, a Legends, proud supporters of Madison Memorial Spartans. They're located at 439 Grand Canyon Drive. Foods, drink, Packers, Badgers, Brewers, and Bucks. All you need at Legends Sports Bar and Grill.
That time the Wildcats winning at the point of attack, and that hasn't happened much here in this football game, especially in the second half, unless Trayvon Johnson's been involved. But right now it has been the Spartans knocking on the doorstep because of their line.
And that's going to fall incomplete in the end zone, intended for Adam Smith Jr. And that's the second time they've tried that corner route to Smith, and both times just out of his grasp.
Almost a situation there where Enright could have ran. We've seen him run, and he's got quick feet, and he has taken off, and I thought that he might run it right there as there was really no one there to challenge him, but he tried the throw. Couldn't get it, and it comes up third down. We also have not seen Goodwin back in the game. That shot that he did take, I'm wondering if he's going through the concussion protocol.
Wea, now the running back, pistol formation. Enright takes it, rolls out to the right, sets his feet, looking to pass across the middle, tosses it to his big wide receiver, Frederick. That's going to go over his hands and fall incomplete. I'm sorry, Ferguson, the intended receiver.
Great job by Mahai there on the sidelines. The camera work sees open receivers, 18's open, 13's open, but he goes back to Ferguson, his big, tall target, and just overshot him. If you overshoot Jake Ferguson, you're overshooting.
Well, you know, he took a chance there, and there was one person that was going to get that ball. It was either going to be him or nobody, as we do in a O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag there on the play. While they're discussing that, I want to thank our friends at Little Caesars in Verona, proud supporters of the Verona High School Wildcats. Dane County's first and only hot and ready pickup window, Little Caesars, go Wildcats.
And it looks like Verona is going to accept the penalty and push Memorial back, as didn't see what the call was right there, but think it might have been a hold, whatever it was. It took him back quite a ways.
Third and goal regardless looked to be at the 20, a long 24-yard line, just about the 25.
So a personal foul.
I missed where that came from. Either way, we have four wide receivers, trips off to the right, single man to the left. Enright, under pressure, rolling off to his right, has the speed, turns it up, rears back, launches one across the middle, and that is going to be ruled incomplete as Adam Smith Jr. took a hit there when the ball got to him.
Great job this time by Enright to get away from the charge. There was Johnson reaching out, all 6 foot five of them. Couldn't get it as Enright throws late over the middle. That's always scary. Almost was able to complete the pass, but what it did, it avoided the sack at least, which would have been disastrous.
Yeah, right off the chest plate there of Smith. All day to look that one in. Those are actually some of the harder catches to make because you have time to think about it.
Absolutely.
3:21 left in the third quarter.
I got it. Oops, I don't got it. Well, this press box is shaking. The fans are into it right now.
Enright, looking to the end zone, goes up, and that's going to be knocked away. Almost pulled down off the tip by Hunter Peters.
Almost an amazing catch. He went up and almost one-handed that with his left hand, but hitting the ground, he wasn't able to bring it in. Almost an amazing catch. But there is a flag down, so there's a little bit of hope here. And it goes against Verona, and it's roughing the passer, and it's going to be a first down.
Good defensive play there by Noah Anderson. That's going to be null and void on that penalty.
Wow.
As that will bring up first and goal for Memorial.
I didn't see it. We pulled away there on the camera on what was roughing, and it might have been a blow to the head because I don't think it was a late hit. I just think he hit him right across the head, and that's what caused the 15 yards and a fresh set of downs now for the Spartans and a big deflating penalty against the Wildcats.
Actually, I was wrong. That will bring up first and 10. They still have an opportunity for another first down as they start from the 12-yard line here. Bataglia once again with his hands in his warmer.
Yeah, behind his back.
Hand off to Wea. Wea pulled down at about the 10-yard line. Might have picked up one on that carry. Want to thank Kelly Stelzer, a proud supporter of local high school athletics. You're knowledgeable and trusted realtor.
Nice job, Evan Fernandez. He's 6'2 and a senior on the tackle on that play. Wea just doesn't seem to have the same kind of explosiveness that we saw from Terrell Goodwin so far in this game. So if you're not finding it from the run, it's been harder to set up for the pass, as Enright now has missed on his last four, and it's because the threat of the run isn't quite there as much as it was with Goodwin in the game.
All right, pistol formation. Enright looking, has a man in the end zone. That's going to fall incomplete. And that was intended once again for Hunter Peters. Peters goes through and just knocked out of his hands there. Could
I'm
have been a touchdown.
I'm kind of surprised down here, yeah, that we haven't seen more of the ball going Ferguson's way. Mm-hmm. I mean, a big, huge target. He's already got seven catches on the night, 104 yards. You would think down here in the goal line this would be a great situation to toss it up to the big fella.
And right on third and eight. Looking to the end zone, that's going to bounce short once again. And that ball was intended for Hunter Peters. Again.
Yeah, again, you know, kind of funny. Peters does have five touchdown catches on the year, has one tonight, so that's actually six, which ties him for Ferguson. But in tighter quarters, I'm thinking the taller guy is the guy you want to shoot for, and right now has misfired on his last six pass attempts.
Well, they're going to try another field goal here. And on the kick is Carl Hummel, who's had a rough night for the Spartans, missing an extra point and a field goal so far this evening. Here's his chance, his vengeance for three, gets one up, and that's going to go wide to the left once again. Hummel missing another one to the left. That's two missed field goals and a missed extra point. That'll leave the score at 13-7 with 2:13 left to go in the third quarter. We'll be back. You're watching the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the A-1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. It is the Cheese Bowl, and the Madison Memorial Spartans are up 13-7 on the Verona Wildcats, who are taking over on offense right now. Hand off up the middle, picking up about 2-3 on the play. Max Fink is the quarterback for the Wildcats. It is senior night here this evening. Big crowd and a big traveling crowd for Memorial as well, as their student section is all in bright pink. Obviously, Breast Cancer Awareness Month here. All right. We have a motion there for Verona. Fink looking to pass. Has a man coming across. That's going to fall incomplete, intended for Hunter Bourne.
So far tonight, Fink has been kind of hit or miss on his pass attempts. 5 for 10, 69 yards. Does have a touchdown. He's also had a couple of them dropped. That's not one of them. That would have been an amazing catch by Bourne. But he has had a pass by Bourne that was dropped over the middle. I think tonight the passing game's been kind of effective, but it's been mostly set up by the run. 115 yards on the ground. 92 of them belong to Carson Parks, who's been able to bust off a couple of long ones. Verona could use one here.
Looking at third and five here for the Wildcats. Motion from left to right. Has the man open, and that's going to fall incomplete behind Hunter Bourne. And Bourne came screaming off the line, and that pass just too far behind him. That one is going to be on Fink.
Actually, a very nice job by the defense, because if you would have thrown it in a spot where Bourne can catch it, he was going to get popped. You could not lead him into that. And so I don't think there was a way that that ball was ever going to be completed. So a nice job by the Spartan D to hold him there.
Verona going to be punting here. High snap. Close to being blocked. And that is going to allow the Spartans to take over at the 45-yard line. So solid field position here for another drive. It is 13-7, so anybody's game right now with 1:27 left in the third.
Yeah, right here, you know, it would be nice. The Spartans have really dominated as far as total yardage. They've dominated as far as time of possession. They've dominated in almost every facet of the game except for special teams. It would be nice if you're the Spartans right now and Coach Smith to get another touchdown drive, though, and put some distance between you and the Wildcats, because one play now and it goes the other way this game.
That will be false start on the offense, and that'll take the Spartans back as we have an O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag on that play.
Jack Peterson over on the right side, and he's been matched up a lot tonight with Trayvon Johnson. And when Trayvon Johnson is over you, you want to get the jump on him. And that time just a little too quick was Peterson.
They'll bring up first and 15 for Memorial.
One thing I like that Coach Richardson does do is that he moves Johnson around. He's never just lined up in one spot.
Enright takes a snap. He's going to toss it off, coming back into the game. That is who we were waiting for, Terrell Goodwin. So he appears to be cleared, and he's back out on the field.
Nice to have him back in the game. That's a good sign. That means that he's doing well. Boy, another shot, though, right there, as Goodwin does kind of lower his head a little bit towards the end of a run, and sometimes that can get you those headshots.
Yeah, that's when you pick him up if you're a hard runner. A lot of guys will just run out of bounds. I like the guys that lower a shoulder and try to pick up that hard extra yard, but it can slow you down quite a bit in the long term. There is a pass to the left side. That's going to be completed to Peters down at about the 33.
And Peters now starting to pile up some yardage, too. That's a gain of 20, and a quick 20 as Peters, 5 catches, 69 yards on the night, and that's the first completion for Enright in his last 7 attempts.
That is a courtesy Ford first down. Courtesy Ford, your new truck destination. Enright waiting for the play call to come in, as we'll get the snap with about a minute left in the third quarter. Enright takes it. He's going to hand it off. And going nowhere is Goodwin. As the seconds are ticking away, 45 left in the third quarter, score 13-7 in favor of Madison Memorial.
I think the Spartans have their most success when they play a little bit more up-tempo. They have the lead, and since they've had the lead, they've kind of slowed the offense down. And I think it might be a little bit to their detriment. When they've been able to move the ball and move it effectively, they've been moving quickly.
Pistol formation. Enright looking's got a man. That's going to be knocked out of his hands. Good defensive play there by Brandon Daniels, the junior, knocking it away from Hunter Peters.
Yeah, we've called his name a couple of times here in the second half. He had a big hit on Goodwin. Now he steps up. Good defensive play. Might have been interference. He had that left arm hooked around the waist, but that's a good savvy play. They don't call that all the time, and if you can get away with it, it's not interference.
14 seconds left in the quarter. Enright running back lined up to the left side. 4 wide receivers, trips to the right. Enright looking to pass, looking for the solo man to his left, and he's going to be pulled down behind the line of scrimmage. And that is going to be a sack. And I believe that was Jake Keyes picking up the sack.
It sure was, as he came in on the blitz, was able to find that hole. Enright, as quick as his feet are, just could not get away. And a big loss on the play and a punt coming up.
All right, that will end the third quarter. Score 13-7 in favor of the Madison Memorial Spartans. We're going to head down to the sideline and be back with football in just a moment.
We've got some familiar faces joining us from Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. These guys have been out here supporting local athletics all season long, and boy, do we appreciate it. John has been with us a couple times on camera, and Chris is joining us now because a really important initiative that Chris is a big part of, as well as Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, Heat Up Wisconsin. We want to get a chance to touch on that tonight. So, Chris, this is kind of your baby. Talk to us a little bit about this.
Well, Heat Up Wisconsin is where Lennox donates the furnaces, and all of the local Lennox dealers through Wisconsin and the UP donate the labor and all the other miscellaneous goods to deserving people. We do an average of 70 to 75. We'd love to hit 100. It's done at the first Saturday of October every year throughout the whole state. So it's just a great thing.
So it's done for this year, but thinking ahead to next year, how do you nominate someone that you think is deserving, that maybe needs that new furnace, that nice new Lennox?
The nominations are open already. Go online to heatupwisconsin.com is the easiest way. You're welcome to come to our website. There's a link there at Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. And it's just an easy, simple thing. Tell the story about the people that are deserving and get them in there all year long.
It makes you think about those folks right now as it starts getting colder, doesn't it?
Absolutely. What a great idea. What a great program. Check that out if you know someone that fits that bill. And we'll go back to football.
Sure will. Thanks to Accu-Clime Mechanical Service.
Well, there's a punt that looks to go into the end zone. So Verona's going to pick it up.
And a big drive coming up here for the Wildcats. They start at their own 20. They're down by one score. It's kind of amazing for as tilted as it has been as far as the stat sheet goes, as far as the yardage goes. It's been all Spartans, but on the scoreboard, it's not. And it's because Verona's been able to hang in with good special teams and good defense, and they give themselves a chance right here in the fourth quarter.
So score 13-7, Verona now has the chance to take the lead on this drive as they're going to be stopped in the backfield. Loss on that play on the carry by Carson Parks.
And a nice job by Ferguson coming in on the run blitz. Also sticking his nose in there is number 74, that's Sam Jessup. He's a 6-foot, 225-pound freshman who is in on the play. That's right, you heard me right, a freshman.
Finks under center, looking to pass, tosses one down to the left side of the field. He has his man, and that's going to be ruled incomplete. It looked like he pulled it down, Jack Herkert. Herkert hands up.
Wow, it just went right through.
And just couldn't grab it. I initially thought that may have been a fumble on Herkert, but no, right call, that ball falls incomplete.
I initially thought it was six. Herkert got three, was down the sideline, had nothing but green in front of him, couldn't haul it in, and couldn't keep his feet. Wow, does the Spartans dodge a bullet right there.
Very much so. That would have at least tied the game, if not given the lead to Verona. Fink under center. Back looking to pass. Screen across the middle, and Spartans read that perfectly.
Beautiful defense that time. Again, it was Sam Jessup, who's a freshman, who was able to stay at home. Wea was also there as well to get the tackle, and a great job by the defense because that looked like a good call by the Wildcats.
And what we have here is Verona driving, stopped by the Spartan defense, and now they're going to be forced to punt. And really, if your Memorial, all you want right now is to control that football and run the clock away to pick up the win here tonight.
Hit him, pick it up and go. That's a free ball.
And that will be at the 44-yard line. And that is where the Spartans will take over on offense.
You actually heard the coaches next to us there for the Spartans, and they're yelling that it's a free ball. It was. Now, once the kicking team actually touches the ball, you can't even fumble at that point. You could try to pick it up. They could push you off the ball. It doesn't matter. It's a free football and a free play, and you got to try and advance that football. You'll see it in the NFL a lot where you're kind of huddled around. If someone on the kicking team touches it, another guy could just come on in, scoop it up, and run.
Yeah, because it's basically a free play at that point in time.
It's a free play. Yep.
And Enright back, three receivers lined up to his right side, single to the left, handoff going to be up the middle. Picks up about two. That is Goodwin once again, the bell cow here for this Memorial Spartan offense.
And just following his block, staying patient, was able to get 4 yards on first down as he's just getting behind those big offensive linemen like John Adam up in the middle there, and also number 75, Ishmael James, who have been dominating their side of the football.
10 minutes to go in the game. Spartans up 13-7 on offense. Handoff once again to Goodwin.
Goodwin now unofficially 171 yards, although in the second half, they've come a lot harder. His average in the second half is just 3.5 yards a carry, where in the first half, he was averaging nearly 10 yards per pop. So the defense has tightened up on Terrell Goodwin.
Now you see the Spartans starting to take a little bit more time getting the plays in.
A lot more time. This isn't what we're used to seeing all night long, but they got the lead, and the time definitely their friend right now.
Waiting the snap here is Enright, running back now lined up from his right to his left. There is a snap. Enright looking to pass. Has a man open, fires it to the sideline, nearly pulled down by Ferguson and off his hands.
And it's been a lot of misfires here lately by Enright. He has completed just one out of his last 8 passes. And what had been a very efficient night is turning completely inefficient. Not sure if it's just a lot of miscues, if there's bad reads out there, or if it's just the Wildcat defense that's been making the difference here in the second half.
Spartans look to punt it away. Ferguson, a big target. And he's been hit several times tonight. That one right off his hands. But Enright, so much time in the pocket to find a receiver.
Absolutely. He's had it all night long, and it's been the great line play again of Memorial. They've just dominated on both sides at the line. It's just been a bad special teams night and a bad field position night, and it's what's been keeping Verona in this football game. And you just kind of get this weird sense about this game. Like, it's not very even. It's not very fluid. And you get this sense that Verona now just has this puncher's chance, and they're ready to break out. They almost had it on the big pass down the sideline. Mm-hmm. They're just about ready to take the lead, and boy, it would really be heartbreaking for the Spartans to lose this football game.
And there is the handoff up the middle. Not picking up much as that Spartan defense continues to hunker down.
Yeah, both coaches were really kind of worried about their defenses tonight, but it's been the defensive play, especially in spots, for both teams and in the second half for both teams, that has been pretty impressive here tonight.
8.5 minutes left in the game. Want to thank A1 Furniture, our official Bowl Series sponsor, locally owned and operated since 1980. Find them on the West Beltline Highway or South Stoughton Road. Fink looking to pass across the middle. That is going to be called incomplete. Looks like he had it from here. That was intended for Lance Andrew. But you see here on the KJ replay that it did just hit the ground. Want to thank Kjerstin Goggin, Dane County's premier realtor. If you're buying or selling, visit kjsellsmadison.com, bringing us all of the replays this season.
2 out of his last 7 is Max Fink is so far on the night. He's been able to complete 5 out of 14 for 69 yards. Not a lot of efficiency, but he hasn't made any mistakes either. No interceptions on the night. Does have the one touchdown pass, the 7-yarder to Longer.
Fink looking to pass. Goes to the one side, the short side of the field, and over his receiver once again. Again, intended for Lance Andrew, and he overthrew him. And Fink just not clicking here with his receivers tonight, and that's been a problem. We hope you guys had the opportunity to tune in to our pregame show brought to you by Al Byers. Feel good in every room of your home with Aprilaire Zone Control available at Al Byers. Feel good inside.
That's such a low percentage throw. You almost get the point that Coach Richardson is saying, you know what, I don't think we could drive the field. I think that we need to get a big play and a big shot like that, because otherwise I think the higher percentage pass plays would work out better here.
And really in the fourth quarter, these teams have just been trading field position as another huge punt for Verona. And they're going to knock that down at about the 35-yard line. And with under 8 minutes to go in the game, it's the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. It's the Cheese Bowl here on CW57 Sports as the Madison Memorial Spartans lead the Verona Wildcats 13-7, under 8 minutes to go in the ball game. And we're talking about it early in the fourth quarter. Verona kind of just feels like they have a puncher's chance here. It feels like the Spartans are kind of a track team that can do what they want, but Verona just playing hard and are still in this ball game. As you see, they're trying to spin out of the tackle. Has been Goodwin, who's had a fantastic night here for Memorial.
Not much going there, and the one thing I think the coaches are going to tell him is, Terrell, bring that football in closer to your body. Twice he threw it way outside, and a fumble here is disaster.
Oh,
so
yeah.
You have got to hold on to that football. Have 3 points of contact on your body with it. Keep it close in, because if that thing gets knocked out, this game flips in an instant.
Big time, and you can see a stark comparison from early in the game to now with this Spartan offense, from really quick no-huddle plays to now taking a lot of time, wearing the clock down, which is what they want to do. Big pass here from Enright. He's going to find Ferguson across the 50 down to the 45, knocked down at about the 41-yard line, and that is a huge play there for the Spartan offense.
21 yards on the pass completion. Enright again, a lot of time. Look at all the time in the pocket. Just moves his feet around a little bit to buy some extra time. It allows Ferguson to have a slow developing route, get open. And as he comes across the middle, he is almost uncoverable because of his height.
We want to thank Mad City Frites. Visit them on State Street and experience the best fries in Madison. Pistol formation, two receivers each side. Now taking the handoff, turning up towards the sideline, breaking towards the end zone, and he's going to run it out of bounds there. Almost looked as if he was running out of steam.
Yeah, great job by the wide receivers over here with the block. And look, it's Ferguson out there on the right side. That's the block that springs him. And Goodwin heading down the right sideline and just kind of stepped out of bounds. I thought he was going to cut back, maybe fight for some more yards. But he took what he got, and a big first down for the Spartans.
Just over 6.5 minutes left.
Goodwin Spartans now closing now in on 200 yards. Sorry, he's got 198.
You'd imagine he'll break 200 tonight then. Pistol formation, trips to the left side of the field, single receiver to the right. Enright takes the snap, goes to the single receiver, spins out of a tackle, walks it in the end zone. That is a touchdown for the Memorial Spartans, and that is Jake Ferguson. Once again, what a move, a J&K Security Solution touchdown. Home theater, home security, now home automation. J&K Security Solutions, integrate your world. And it wasn't just the route and the catch. It's what he did after he got the ball in his hands.
The big junior breaks one tackle, spins out of it, sheds another, dances into the end zone. And that could be the nail in the coffin for the Verona Wildcats. Great throw by Enright and a nice job by Ferguson on that spin move. Wow, to dance out of trouble. And the 6'5" junior has the touchdown catch tonight. It was just like I said on the last drive. You got to throw it to Ferguson when you get close to the goal line. It's there. It's just like stealing.
Unbelievable. Impressive play there. Timeout taken by the Memorial Spartans. We will have the extra point, which should be interesting with Hummel kicking, in just a moment. We're going to take a look at that replay once again.
Yeah, and as far as big plays goes, and we've had a few tonight, this might be the play of the game right here. And good footwork by Ferguson to go ahead and spin and dance his way out and then see that end zone and get himself in there. And a touchdown for the Spartans, who now are up by more than two touchdowns tonight. So really big, big play there, and a good throw by Enright, but an even better catch and run by Ferguson.
That'll have us at 19-7 right now. We still have the extra point attempt, which could make it 20-7. And Carl Hummels had a rough night. Kickings missed one extra point and missed two field goal attempts. And it looks as if Spartans are going to go for two. There is the pistol formation. Trips off to the left. Single receiver Ferguson to the right. Direct snap. And he's going to decide to keep it spin around. And that was,
that's good.
That is unbelievable as you had Jason Wheeler.
And here comes the flag. I was going to say, there has to be a flag on that. It's got to be an illegal man downfield, isn't it?
Jason Wheeler under pressure. going down and just tosses one into the end zone. We'll await the call here. But here you see as Wea goes down, he just tosses one into the end zone. And actually,
I'm looking at it. I see four linemen downfield behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
Unless it's 53 that he called here.
And they're waving it off.
Yeah, that's probably the right call.
Yeah, great job there by the lineman.
Yep.
To stay onside. Unbelievable. So they're going to wave that off. And here you see Wea eating up in the backfield and just kind of haphazardly tosses one.
78. They're all behind the line.
In the end zone. And pulling that down is Adam Smith Jr. on the 2-point conversion. The flag is waved off.
And
we're going to dissect that. That will make it 21-7. We're going to take a short break. You are watching the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Verona, the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. It's the Cheese Bowl as the Spartans are ready to kick off. Up 21-7 with 6:26 left to go in the game, and you just saw one of the weirder two-point conversions you will ever see as another shallow kickoff return past the 30, down, ripped hard at the 35.
Big hit on a cold night, and they're always a little bit harder when it's cold outside when you get a hit like that. I mean, it's so cold tonight. My soda's staying perfectly cold without any ice in it. So, you know, it's just one of those nights, and, you know, it kind of stings when you get a hit like that. But you talked about the two-point conversion, one of the weirder plays. Very strange that you might actually take a two-point conversion and nominate it for play of the game. That
I was just
never
thinking
happens.
The same thing. Yeah. And you saw there, you saw in the close-up, the return man there for Verona, Austin Powers, was not happy at being taken down so hard.
Austin
Powers?
That
was a clean
hit. Really
Austin Powers, that is his
name. His name was Austin Powers? That's awesome.
I bet you he gets... He's got his mojo going tonight as Fink tosses another one incomplete. Fake the handoff, fires it across the middle. Another incomplete pass. Max Fink, you know what? His passes aren't bad. His receivers just aren't pulling him in for him tonight, not giving him any help at all.
Absolutely not. Austin Powers, huh? So there must be 1 million jokes that he's heard about that name in his life.
At least, I don't know. Are these kids... Like, when did Austin Powers come around? Are they too young to know
they
Austin
might
Powers?
Be, yeah. When was the last one? Was like 2002, 2003?
It was
with
early
Beyonce
2000s.
That was about it.
And Fink with a big end-around fake handoff launches one to the far side of the field. That's going to fall incomplete, and that almost just looked like a desperation throw out of Fink.
Yeah, again, it looks like the Wildcats going for it all on one play. But now you're down by two scores,
yep.
And you got to try and just take what the defense gives you. And it seems like they're kind of forcing it here in the fourth quarter.
And as we said, we do got to decide on an Accu-Clime Mechanical Services play of the game. Right now, call now, get $40 off thorough and professional precision tune-up of your furnace. Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, you'll feel just right. And it could be that two-point conversion. I love that play. That was funny. And Fink, again, that is going to be knocked down to the line of scrimmage.
And it's Wea who
Spartans.
Got up there. Yeah,
that's Wea getting
that.
Up there and knocking it down.
He got off the ground that time. Good hops by Wea to go ahead and knock that pass down. And they teach you that. As a defensive lineman, if you can't get to the quarterback, get your hands up and jump. Get up in the air. Knock that pass down. Good job. Good coaching.
So in the background of that KJ replay, Coach Smith going nuts on the sideline.
Yep.
He's an excited guy down there. All right. Looking. Another booming punt. This one goes high. And it's going to go off the helmet of a Wildcat.
Yeah, if it went off his helmet, I think they got to bring
yeah,
it
Yeah, they'll
back
mark
or,
it down
yeah,
there. So exactly. It'll be marked down at about the 30-yard line as it goes right off the helmet of Quan Clements.
Yeah, you got to say here tonight, Verona has been game. They were in this game a long time. But I think, you know, the more athletic team, the faster team, the stronger team all night long has been the Spartans. And it's kind of shown. They have 412 total yards. Verona so far in the night, 186. It has been the Spartans football game to win, and now it's starting to bear itself out on the scoreboard.
Well, and
for a while there, we couldn't tell if it was going
and now with less than 6 minutes to go in the ball game, you're going to see a lot of run the clock out, I would assume, up for by 14 points. You see a big backfield here now for the Spartans. And Wright going to hand it off, going to go up the middle, not pick up a thing. But as we said, that'll take some precious seconds off the clock as the Spartans are just going to try to run this one out.
Right up to Wea there. And, you know, one of the adjustments I think that was made at halftime, too, was getting away from Trayvon Johnson. We called Trayvon Johnson's number a lot in the first half, and he was dominating the play along the defensive line. In the second half, we haven't seen him at all. I'm not even sure he has a tackle here in the second half. I mean, he had a strip of a football and a fumble recovery, and he was getting, you know, losses, tackles for losses. And, you know, he was everywhere in the first half. But here in the second half, we've not called Trayvon Johnson's name.
And Wright on the option, going to toss it off and hit hard.
And a fumble.
Is Goodwin.
Nope, they called it down. Okay.
Goodwin was down. That was a hard lick. See here on the KGA replay, Enright keeps it, tosses out to Goodwin. Great downfield tackle. And, yeah, Goodwin will be down before that ball comes out. That's the right call.
Wow, it's kind of hard to tell. We don't have the replay on the other side. That ball might have been coming down. It was finally dislodged by the ground, which doesn't make it a fumble, but a good lick. And Goodwin's taking some shots here in the second half.
And here they're going to take those backs and spread them out. Bring him four wide receivers, pistol set up, handoff to Goodwin. Goodwin going to be eaten up in the backfield. And now under 4.5 minutes left to go in the ball game. That will bring up fourth and long. So you would expect to see the Spartans punt as Verona takes a timeout. That is a Toyota timeout. Toyota, let's go places.
Goodwin now getting farther away from that 200-yard mark as he's down to 192.
And we do want to thank Kelly Stelzer. Goodwin could be in the running there for that Kelly Stelzer MVP award. Kelly Stelzer, proud to support local high school athletics, your knowledgeable and trusted realtor. And as we're on the timeout, also one more time, want to thank my good friends David and Dooley from over at Legends. They're proud supporters of Madison Memorial Spartans. Legends Sports Bar is at 439 Grand Canyon Drive in Madison. Great food, great drinks. You can watch the Packers, Badgers, Brewers, and Bucks. Get everything you need at Legend Sports Bar and Grill. You might see me over there after the game tonight, actually.
Nice. Nothing wrong with that.
No. Nice place to hang out, not far from home.
I haven't been there in a while.
Well, maybe you can go with me tonight. David will buy us around. We got an interview with David. And here is going to be the punt with under 4.5. Short punt. Going to bounce, returned at about the 40, has a man in front of him, returned out to the 45. Good block as he crossed the 50 down to the 45, 40. 35, turns around to the 30. Spins out and going to be taken down at about the 29-yard line. Good return there, and with over 4 minutes left of the ball game, Verona, good field position. This ball game is not over yet.
And it's not over yet again because of the special teams of the Wildcats. Great blocking down the field as they were able to break free. Drew King with a big return, his second big return of the night. Great field position. And now the Wildcats will look to strike quickly to get back in this football game.
4:10 left. Scores 21-7 in favor of the Madison Memorial Spartans. Verona, I would imagine, is going to want to pick up the tempo here a little bit from what they've had most of the game. Single back. Kind of a wing T formation here. Vink looking to the end zone, tosses one up, and no one even near it. And that's been a problem. And, well, there is a late penalty flag that comes out, and a O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag. That was not in the area of intentional grounding. It might have been unsportsmanlike here on the near side of the field. Going to kind of wait for that call.
Yeah, definitely marching it back against the Wildcats as Fink now has missed on his last six. Yep, unsportsmanlike. And, wow, that's a big penalty. That's the third time that the Wildcats have had a 15-yard penalty against them tonight. Mm-hmm.
And those are mental mistakes. That's hurting your team.
Absolutely.
Unsportsmanlike conducts. Those are that's not playing hard. It's doing something dumb.
Well, when you have 186 yards of total offense, that's it. And now you have 60 yards in penalties. You only have 126 yards of total offense. And those hidden things that end up hurting you in a football game.
That's about what the Spartans had in the first quarter. And there's another incomplete pass thrown by Fink. And you can just tell by his mannerisms after that pass, he is frustrated.
Seven misfires in a row. He had a completion for 0 yards. Before that, he had three misfires in a row. So Fink really struggling here to get the passing game going. Only 69 yards on 20 attempts.
And I think we've touched on a couple times. I don't think it's Fink's passing. The receivers aren't helping him out much at all either.
Well, and here, too, in the fourth quarter, they seem to be forcing the issue, and it's been a good job of defense by the Spartans.
There is going to be a handoff off the middle. He's going to be stopped after a short gain. Pulling that down once again was Carson Parks, who we expected to see quite a bit of tonight. Had a solid game, but maybe not as much as we would have anticipated, as now Verona is facing a fourth and 15.
Well, with that carry for Parks, it does put him at 100 yards. 12 carries, 100 yards, and 8.3 average for Parks. Just hasn't been getting the football enough as the Wildcats have been behind.
Fink diagramming his pass to the left. And he's going to complete it, but that's not going to be anywhere near enough for a first down. Might be back to the original line of scrimmage. And that will give the Madison Memorial Spartans the ball back with 3:22 left in the ball game, up 21-7.
And not sure why you'd do that. It just doesn't make any sense. If you got fourth down and whatever the yardage is, fourth and 15, you got to throw it 16 yards. If you got fourth and 26, you got to throw it 27 yards. It's just the way that it works, and you don't have fourth and 15 and throw the ball 5 yards. You can't make the conversion.
And what we're going to see here is the Spartans continuing to run the ball, running some seconds off the clock, and eventually just beating Verona here. Unless there's some big turnover, and just
that's
as
what
I
you
say
think,
that,
running the ball.
Enright launches one off to Ferguson and throws an interception, and Verona's going to take back over on the opposite 35-yard line. So disregard everything I just said. You know, and obviously you'd think Verona was expecting him to just run it down there too, but Enright launches one down the sideline. That'll be picked off and give Verona the ball back. I don't understand that call.
That's a stumper, but it was a really nice catch by number 15, Noah Anderson, 6 feet, a junior, caught it like a wide receiver, stretched out for it, got the interception. Yeah, it doesn't make a lot of sense right there as the Wildcats get the ball back quickly now. Maybe you just have a lot of trust in your defense.
That could be it too. And the way they've been playing, I'd have trusted them as well. Fink now tosses one. That's going to be completed. And that'll be a courtesy Ford first down, picking up a couple more, push out of bounds. There will be Nick Lawinger. Lawinger having a good quiet night as well.
Second catch of the night for Lawinger. Just 8 first downs so far tonight for the Verona Wildcats.
Another courtesy Ford first down from the 36-yard line. 3:05 left.
And a penalty flag, and this is going to go against Verona.
Holding on Verona.
Wow.
So that'll march him back even more with that O'Reilly Auto Parts penalty flag. Want to thank the Vancek family of Little Caesars Pizza in Verona, proud supporters of Verona High School Wildcats. Little Caesars Pizza, Dane County's first and only hot and ready pickup window. Little Caesars, go Wildcats. Is that like a drive-through pickup window for that pizza?
I don't know. I haven't been there. Yeah,
I'm going to have to check that out. Maybe that's where our producer, Tony, got into his wreck. In the drive-thru of the Little Caesars.
Was it a little old lady that hit him? I think it was.
I think it was. She hit him hard, too.
The little old lady from Pasadena.
All right, Verona. Looking to pass here. There is going to be another incompletion intended. Once again for Lawinger, and still really have no idea what happened with that penalty as they marched him back, then brought him all the way back up.
Yeah, it was a holding call, but it was a holding call way downfield.
It must have been.
Yeah. So they ended up marching off 10 yards against him, and it still wasn't a first down. So they were able to keep the down but in some yardage out of the whole play. Mm-hmm. But still, there's a lot of hidden yards there. I mean, 70 total yards and penalties against the Wildcats tonight.
And now hustling the line with 3 minutes left in the ball game is the Verona Wildcats. Fink under center. Fink looking to the left side, looking to pass, pump fakes, resets, tosses it down the middle, and that is going to be right off the hands of the linebacker for Memorial, Jack Andringa.
Andringa, we've seen him on offense, hasn't made too much of a splash here on defense, but had a chance right there, and hands like feet, he'll tell you, as it went right through his hands and hits the ground for the incompletion when it could have been an interception.
Third and five now for Verona. Fink has the play coming into the huddle. Once again, 21-7 in favor of Madison Memorial. And with the motion there, going to be handed off up the middle. And that is going to go to Parks, who's not going to have enough for the first down. So now a matter of if Verona wants to go for it or if they're going to punt it away. Really nothing to lose here going for it. Fourth and a long one, down by 14 here with under 3 minutes in the ball game.
They are compelled to go for it here.
Finks might take it himself, and that he does as he charges ahead. Well, he has the initial first down, but there is a penalty flag on the play. And that's probably in the area of someone moving on that offensive line.
Yeah, I'm not sure if everyone was set yet or if someone actually lined up off sides. And we'll see what they call. And it was motion. They just weren't set.
Yeah, that's going to happen on those quick turnaround plays. So illegal procedure is the official call.
And now it means, you know, if you're Fink, you got to go back to the air, and that's really been difficult so far in this game. Just 7 completions out of 23 attempts for 76 yards tonight.
So making it a little farther, fourth down, now fourth and 6 for the Wildcats. Fink looking to pass, fires one, and that'll be knocked down once again. And wouldn't you guess that was Jason Wheel once again for the Spartans knocking that pass away.
Nice job by Wheel on defense. Once again, we had just talked about that play, but Fink now tonight completing less than 30% of his passes.
All right, 2 minutes, 11 seconds left, and the Spartans are up 21-7. We'll be right back with the A1 Furniture Bowl Series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to the A1 Furniture Bowl Series here on CW57 Sports. There is going to be another run up the middle, and that is Goodwin, who's having a solid game here, and that'll take the clock down under 2 minutes left to go. Actually, they will be taking a timeout there, and that will be charged to Verona. So Verona taking a Toyota timeout, bringing 2:04 left on the clock, 21-7 the score. And barring something insane happening, you're going to think the Spartans are going to walk away with a win here, bringing them to 7-2 and a very impressive season here tonight.
And after starting the season 0-2, to come back and win 7 straight, and a great job by the coaching staff as well and Coach Smith. So you got to like that. And I think, you know, tonight the only thing that's left up to debate for us is who's going to be player of the game.
Yeah.
There's definitely a couple of candidates. If I'm going to throw my vote in there, I'm going for Jake Ferguson, and I'll tell you why. Not only did he do a great job, I mean, tonight 9 catches, 140 yards, and a touchdown. On the defensive side of the ball, he was there as well.
Mm-hmm.
We called his number quite a bit, had some big hits. I like Ferguson over Goodwin for player of the game, but I thought I'd
all
throw
right.
it out there.
I like where your head's at.
All right.
And there is going to be another run up the middle for Goodwin. And now the Spartans running the clock out.
They're not going to throw another bomb here, is he?
You know what? I'm not saying
you can't
no.
Be sure.
With Adam calling the plays and Enright slinging the ball, I'm not ruling it out.
I wouldn't either. That would really be rubbing it in at this point, though, wouldn't it?
It might be.
It might, just a little bit.
I don't have a problem with that, though. If you don't like me scoring points on you, stop me.
Okay, Bill Belichick.
Hey, it's a game. I play the game to win. It's not unsportsmanlike. You're the one. You came out on the field and wanted to play against me.
Well,
as Wida takes it up the sidelines. Touchdown, Madison Memorial Spartans. And that is Jason Wida with a big run down the sideline for a J&K Security Solution touchdown, making the score 27-7 with 1:13 left in the ball game.
And that's the cherry on top of the sundae, yep, right there. 35 yards for the touchdown. Jason Wea going around the right side. Good blocking. Puts the Spartans over 200 total yards rushing for the day. And a nice day for Jason Wea as well, both offensively and defensively, as he's a late entrant, maybe a little too late for player of the game. But a nice game tonight by Wea.
Fantastic play there by Wea, just driving it home. Extra point up and, oh, he almost got it off the upright. The worst luck tonight for Carl Hummel.
One of the interesting things, I think, if you watch the National Football League, and I know a lot of us do, Mike Nugent had a kick that he doinked in to beat the Seattle Seahawks. Mm-hmm. It actually turns out that according to scientists, and I think it was what's his name? Tyson DeGrasse or
Neil
whatever.
DeGrasse Tyson.
Neil DeGrasse. Yeah, there you go. I forget his whole name. Mm-hmm. Anyways, he said that the rotation of the earth helped the kick go
I
in.
I did see that.
By 1/3 of an inch, it mm-hmm. rotated while the ball was in the air and got the kick in.
I did see
How
that.
How amazing is that?
So
1/3 of an inch it gave him, and that's all he needed.
And Gaglianone for the Badgers bounced a couple in last week.
Yeah.
As well.
Oh,
well,
my
bounced
goodness.
One out and then bounced one in.
He drives me crazy.
But he's really funny on Twitter. 1:13 left of the ball game, 27-7. Another kickoff here for the Spartans. Returned at about the 22-yard line, running from left to right. Turns it up, and he'll be taken down just across the 30. So that'll take us to 1 minute, 5 seconds left in the ball game, and it looks like the Wildcats are going to end up falling here at home on senior night, but their season is not over. They will continue and play into the playoffs this season, as will the Spartans. The Wildcats finishing the season at 6-3, and the Spartans finishing at a very impressive 7-2.
Yeah, their seasons are not over yet. Our season is. So this is the last game that we're doing this year. And I tell you what, thank you so much for having me and inviting me along. I got to mm-hmm. do 7 games with you, and I absolutely love this. Love working with the staff and everybody that's been involved, and Ken, who's directing tonight, and Brennan all year, and Mahai, and Tony, and of course being next to you, and heck, even the girls at halftime and postgame and stuff. I think it's just a lot of fun, and I'm glad we get to do these games.
Me too. Been a very fun season. My first full season here, as well as Fink tosses one, and that's going to fall incomplete, and that's kind of been his MO for the night. Another incompletion there for Verona as the clock runs out. And we want to thank you guys for following us all season long here on the A1 Furniture Bowl Series. It's been a lot of fun tonight, of course, the Cheese Bowl, and we're in Verona for the Wildcats, and they're taking on the Madison Memorial Spartans. And this has been one of the closer games we've had all season. We've had a number of big blowouts throughout the year, which we did not anticipate, but regardless, the opportunity to talk to a lot of these student athletes and coaches and fans has truly been an honor. As another long pass, that'll be an interception, and that will be Hunter Peters pulling it down for Madison Memorial. So I would imagine you'll see the Spartans come out in victory formation here and run the clock out.
Absolutely, and yeah, you talk about some of these, you know, getting to meet the kids, the coaches, going to all these stops. We got to see some wonderful stadiums, great fans, even some good bands at halftime.
Very good bands at halftime.
I mean, it's just been a great season, and to think when we started this and doing this a couple months ago, we were sweating, and it was hot, and right now I got my thermal gear on here tonight.
It's
because
a cold
it's chilly
night,
tonight.
And there is the kneel. And they're going to need about one more here. And that will end the game. A fantastic night, especially if you're a Madison Memorial Spartan fan, or as Coach Adam Smith would say, a member of Spartan Nation.
And they didn't end the season on a seven-game win streak. They ended the season by resetting the standard, and that's what Coach Smith wanted.
Yep.
It's a new standard, a new culture for the Spartans, and seven straight wins heading into the playoffs. Boy, have they got some momentum going into the postseason here.
And we will see what happens with the rest of the games, but there is still a chance that Memorial wins the division. We got to see what happens up with Sun Prairie yet.
Well, and Middleton.
Or
actually.
Middleton, yeah. I apologize. Middleton.
Yep. Cardinals.
They're both Cardinals and red and white.
I know what you meant.
On opposite sides of Madison.
Yeah.
There's too many Cardinals.
They're everywhere. It's
not even an intimidating mascot.
Not in baseball anymore, though. They got knocked out. That was all right.
Oh, thank goodness. That's the only time you'll ever hear me cheer for the Cubs is when they're facing the Cardinals. I'll tell you that much. But once again, a fantastic ball game. Verona not playing a bad game. Just couldn't get the offense clicking here this evening. And the Spartans clicking on offense and defense. We knew they had a potent offense coming in. Didn't air it out as much as we anticipated. But when they did, Ferguson played a big part in the ball game. And you had some fantastic running for a number of guys that made the difference. And at the end, it was 27-7 in favor of the Madison Memorial Spartans. And that's basically what it comes down to, is they win the Cheese Bowl and the final regular season game of the season. We are going to take a break and come back with the Accu-Clime Mechanical Services play of the game. You are tuned into the A-1 Furniture Bowl series on CW57 Sports. Welcome back to Verona. It is the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl series, where the Madison Memorial Spartans just defeated the Verona Wildcats 27-7. It is time for the Accu-Clime Mechanical Services play of the game. And with all the great plays we had for the Spartans, this one was my favorite, and I get the final decision. So it's the play of the game, as you have Jason Wea from Memorial. Folks, this was a two-point conversion. That's how my sense of humor works. Wea running off to the left-hand side, getting tackled on the end around, and just here at the last minute as he's going down, just throws it in the air, and you have Adam Smith Jr. pulling it down for the two-point conversion. Just look at the control by Wea. Just whoop!
It's
Smith, whoop!
Just
Smith gets knocked down
to chuck it up and say, you know, why not? It's a two-point conversion anyways. Let me just get rid of this thing, and there it is for the
and,
2 points.
And how about AJ just being in the right place at the right time, Adam Smith Jr., to pull that one down from Wea and then take a shot and hold on to the ball? That will be your Accu-Clime Mechanical Services play of the game, a two-point conversion. We are just sending a desperation toss up, pulled down by Adam Smith Jr. on a two-point conversion. Once again, the final 27-7 here in Verona, as the Spartans have defeated the Verona Wildcats to go to 7-2 on the season. Both of these teams will be playing next week in postseason play. Once again, my name's Ryan Ashker. This is Rich Reynolds, and we have the player of the game, the statue presentation, or at least what's left of the statue presentation, and an interview with Coach Adam Smith coming up. You are tuned in to the Cheese Bowl, part of the A1 Furniture Bowl series, right here on CW57 Sports.
Excitement here on the field. What do you think, Janet?
I think pretty loud and proud.
Yeah,
is what
I think
it
so.
Like.
And rightfully so. Welcome back to the A1 Furniture Cheese Bowl. We're here at the post-game show in Verona, where the Madison Memorial Spartans have just defeated the Verona Wildcats. Big win for these guys. Congrats. Congrats. Yeah! And we are going to present to the player of the game. We have Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, some familiar faces joining us tonight, who are going to present to number 5, Jason Wea.
Hey!
The play of the game tonight. So I'm going to hand it over to Chris and let him congrats.
On behalf of Accu-Clime Mechanical Services, congratulations to the Memorial Spartans on a big win tonight. Yeah!
Congratulations to Jason Weir for player. Good job.
Thank you.
2-point conversion, and that's our player of the game brought to you by Accu-Clime Mechanical Services. We have a group of very excited Spartans with us, and we've got more post-game show here at the A1 Furniture Cheese Bowl, so stick around.
Welcome back. You're at the conclusion of Wildcats versus Madison Memorial Spartans. Behind us, we have some very excited Spartans from Madison Memorial. Yeah! This is the A1 Furniture Bowl Series, the Cheese Bowl, and we have more awards to give away. Right now, we have the most valuable player, and we are very pleased to present this award thanks to Kelly Stelzer. So this is the Kelly Stelzer most valuable player of the game, and with us to receive it is number 8, Jake Ferguson. Jake, congratulations. Looks like
touchdowns. 140 yards. Nine catches and a touchdown. That'd be great.
Thank
you'd
you.
Really be.
I couldn't have done it without the boys, though. Yeah.
Nine catches, 140 yards, and a touchdown for number 8. So Kelly Stelzer, MVP award, rightfully deserved. What a great team effort, and congrats for your contributions to this team.
Thank you. Thank you.
Don't worry, we've got lots more of this award ceremony. We've got the big one we're going to give away here at the A1 Furniture Cheese Bowl in Verona, and the Madison Memorial Spartans are excited to bring us to break. Right, guys? Yeah! As you can see, we still have an excited group of guys here, and rightfully so. This is the conclusion of our season, but your season will continue, and what a fantastic season you've had. The Madison Memorial Spartans have just defeated the Verona Wildcats on their home turf, and the Spartans are proudly here visiting, and a 7th straight win. Is that right, Coach Smith?
That is right, and we like to say this is a standard. We've set a standard for the way that we're going to be playing ball from here on out, and it's not a big surprise to us. This is what we expect, and we're going to hopefully keep it rolling here.
Well, congrats to you. Maybe a familiar face here at the CW57. You may recognize Coach Smith, but he has done a great job with this team, and this team is a well-deserving recipient of this great award.
So, Coach Smith, we're going to present this to you. This is on behalf of A1 Furniture and CW57 Sports. This is the Cheese Bowl trophy. Congratulations to you and your Spartans.
Thank you.
Where's the Cheese Bowl?
Don't touch it.
It's a delicate trophy here tonight. So we're going to let Rich and Ryan head in here.
That's so heavy.
It's a heavy trophy, we're telling you. Rich and Ryan are going to come on in and ask Coach some more questions. Come if you can get in here.
Thank you. So what we were talking about before the game, you just mentioned it. This isn't a turnaround. This is the new standard you're trying to set at Memorial. And I got to bring it back just from our relationship together. Is this the Spartans climbing the mountain?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We've been preaching since we met with them the first time that's our kind of mantra, along with pound the rock. And we got to pound the rock to get up the mountain. Mm-hmm. And guys have taken a hold of it and run with it. And that's what we're trying to do every day. We have to work together. Everybody in our Spartan Nation has got to be pulling in the same direction. It's the only way we're going to get to the top of the mountain.
Yep.
And so far we're making a nice ascend up there.
Coach, I tell you what, you talk about pounding the rock. You guys were able to pound it over 200 yards rushing, but you were able to throw the ball too. You did a great job on defense. You guys got a balanced team back here, don't you?
Absolutely, and I think that's been what has propelled us from the third game on. Is we've got some people back. We've been balanced. We've been working and concentrating on being that way. Our defense is coming along great. Brad Murphy's done a great job in his side of the ball and the staff. And our O-line coach, Austin Corrales, done a fantastic job getting our offensive line ready every single week so that we're able to be balanced. And it's just a great team effort, a great team work ethic. And we're excited to keep this going next week.
Well, Adam, we want to not only congratulate you on the Cheese Bowl, we want to congratulate you on a 7-2 season, fantastic season.
We're not
done yet. You're not done yet. So as balanced as you guys look going forward, we want to hope Memorial goes a long way into the playoffs. What are some things you got to work on, or what's the next step in order to get in the playoffs and keep being competitive?
We don't have enough time. We gotta work on a lot of stuff. You know, it's amazing that, you know, even though we're 9 games in, mm-hmm. we still have a lot of work to do, and we'll talk to these guys about that. We're excited about coming here and doing something that hasn't ever been done here, and that's defeating Sun Prairie, Middleton, and Verona. It's the first time a Memorial team has ever done that. So it's again the standard that we are setting here, what these seniors are laying down the foundation for our youth coming up and our underclassmen. It's a great feeling, and we're excited to be able to be on this journey.
Well, good luck the rest of the season. We're pulling for you.
Appreciate it, Ash. Thanks.
All right. Congratulations, Spartans. A huge win tonight at Cheese Bowl. You'll see these guys in the playoffs. We want to thank you guys for tuning into the A1 Furniture Bowl Series all season long here on CW57 Sports. For Jessa, Janet, Rich, Tony, the whole crew, my name's Ryan Ashker. We'll see you right here on CW57 Sports.